Honey, I think I found the problem.
Want an easy way to keep your engine clean? Use Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines. They meet the tough standards to help keep your engine running its best. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines.
On the second day of the 2007 NCAA lacrosse tournament, a heavy underdog brings heart and hustle into hostile territory. Led by the toughest face-off man in the nation, the Delaware Blue Hens visit Charlottesville, where the defending NCAA champions just might have the best attack man in the country. Will this be the beginning of a Cinderella story or the first step in Virginia's bid to repeat as national champions? It's Delaware versus Virginia next on ESPNU. Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. And we're at Klockner Stadium in beautiful, sunny Charlottesville, Virginia, where today it's the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens taking on the defending national champion, Virginia Cavaliers. It is an opening round game in the Men's Lacrosse Championship. Virginia and Delaware at the bottom of the screen. The winner of this game to play tonight's winner between Maryland and the University of Maryland, Baltimore County. That game next Sunday at Navy. Earlier, Johns Hopkins, a one-goal winner in overtime over Notre Dame, and the same for Georgetown over Princeton. That's the bottom half of the bracket. Now to the other half of the bracket, Duke an easy winner over Providence. They await the winner of Navy and North Carolina being played at the same time as this game. Already, Albany and Cornell have advanced in the other brackets. And hi again, everybody. I'm Dave Cohen along with Mark Dixon. And first things first, happy Mother's Day to all the moms who've raised these great lacrosse players, took them to all those Little League games and supported them throughout their college careers. Now to the game at hand, Mark. Virginia trying to repeat as national champs, trying to make it three titles in 5 years. Delaware's only in the tournament for the fourth time. They are definitely the underdogs. What do the fighting Blue Hens have to do to make this competitive?
Whenever you play Virginia, you have to talk about tempo because Virginia likes to run and gun. In order for Delaware to be successful today, they'll have to control the tempo and the face-off X to secure those possessions.
Well, lacrosse is the ultimate team game, but always opportunities for individuals to stand out. Let's take a look at the Dick's Sporting Goods key players of this contest.
Well, we talk about face-offs, and for Delaware, Alex Smith is the man at the square. Midfield-wise, Jordan Hall is a leading scorer, and Rob Smith anchors a defense that will have its hands full with the powerful tandem for Virginia of Ben Rubior and Danny Gladding. And between the pipes for the Cavaliers is Kip Turner, the seasoned senior, leading that defense.
Ben Rubior needs 2 goals for 50 this season and 100 in his career.
A Tuaraton finalist, the slick left-handed attackman from Towson, Maryland, Loyola High School, has had a 7-goal game this year against Towson. He scored 5 twice, including 1 against Maryland in a key ACC win. Ben Rubior, an outstanding attackman, one of the best in the country.
In this game of lacrosse, face-offs are key, and we've got the best face-off man this year, maybe of all time in the NCAA, Alex Smith of Delaware.
Alex Smith, the senior out of Lutherville, Maryland, Boys Latin High School, winning 74% of his draws. The Colonial Athletic Association Player of the Year. That's saying a lot for a face-off man. That gives you an idea of how special he is to this Delaware team.
And the last line of defense for any team in lacrosse is the goalie. And the goalie, Kip Turner for Virginia, has never lost a game here at Klockner Field. We're back with lacrosse on ESPNU after this.
The NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships exclusively on ESPNU. Just 4 more victories left to be crowned this year's champion. Anything less and the season is over. The championships continue with UMBC versus Maryland next on ESPNU.
Homeowners, want to refinance and get cash? Countrywide has a great reason to do it now. A no-cost refi. It has no points, no application fee, no credit reporting fee, and no third-party fees, no title, escrow, or appraisal fees. Absolutely no closing costs, so you'll wind up with a lot more cash. Call now and ask for a no-cost refi. We're America's number one home loan lender, and no one can do what Countrywide can. Call 1-800-641-7136.
Dish Network Pay-Per-View gives you three easy ways to order your favorite movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment. It's as simple as pressing a button when you order Pay-Per-View by remote. If you're on the web, go to dishnetwork.com/PPV and order online. Or call 1-877-DISH-PPV to order by phone. All the latest movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment are right at your fingertips. And with three easy ways to order, nothing could be more convenient. Order Dish Network Pay-Per-View today.
The NCAA Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. And in part by Jack Link's Beef Jerky. Feed your wild side. And they're seated on the hill here at Klockner Stadium, sun-drenched. And it's dry out there. And they're getting ready for the opening faceoff, which should tell us something about how this game might progress. You'll see in number 11, well, number one there is the goalie Tommy Scheer for Delaware. His counterpart is Kip Turner, number 15. He was in the nets for the national championship in the undefeated season a year ago. And here is the all-important faceoff. Adam Fasnacht on the right in the white, and there is Alex Smith. We're underway, and the first faceoff of the game still being contested, and it's going to go to Delaware.
What you'll notice about Delaware is that they face off with two shorties on the wing.
And here's a shot and a save immediately by Scheer off the shot by Alex Smith.
Great save by Turner, Dave. If that one could have gone, that would have been a huge lift for Delaware, but nice start for the senior netminder.
Now here is Virginia in transition. Game slowing down a little bit as Virginia will work from behind on their first offensive foray of the afternoon. This is Dan Gladding, number 9, being checked by Crowther Washburn, Evan Crowther Washburn. Now here is Ben Rubio. Easy to spot with the black brace on his right leg.
Hurt that knee against Duke in the matchup in the regular season. Was hobbled somewhat, but is back almost to full strength.
He sends it up top and out to the near side. They'll work it from here and again out front. No shot yet. Here's a shot and a score. Immediately by number 12, Drew Thompson. And here's a guy who had only one goal in his last two games. And so he gets off the schneid early.
We mentioned Thompson at the beginning of the broadcast. He's a senior, one of the captains for Virginia. And he's definitely an unsung hero. Just a simple exchange back up top. And he goes man to man against the long pole for Delaware. Beats him by about a step and a half. Just a great bull dodge to his strength, his right hand. And high to high beats Tommy Scheer far post. Thompson, his 9th goal of the season, his first this afternoon.
Drew Thompson, a senior from Northport, Long Island. And following the goal, we had one of the mandatory stick checks performed by our officials here. And we're out for the second faceoff again. On the left, Alex Smith. And a violation. And the ball will go over to Virginia.
Guarantee that Dom Starcia in his pregame meeting with the official said, watch number 11, Alex Smith for Delaware, jumping early. That time it looks like they got him.
Ryan Calabrese, number 38, has come on defensively for Delaware. Again, Virginia works from behind. This is number 19, Garrett Billings. He sends it outside to Steve Giannone. Giannone beats his man, has room with the left hand. And let's see if that ball stays in bounds. It does. Virginia maintains possession. And shoved out of bounds legally, so the ball goes over to Delaware.
Terrific slide as we see Bob Schillinglaw looking on. 262 career wins, as he's fourth among active Division I coaches, his 29th year at the University of Delaware. And he has to enjoy that defense, Dave. Nice poke check to disrupt the pass, and then a nice physical check using the end line as your friend and pushing Gladding out of bounds. Delaware now with an offensive push.
And Schillinglaw, the dean of all the coaches in this NCAA tournament, we have an offsides call against Delaware.
And here we take a look at Dom Starcia. Winner of multiple national championships here at the University of Virginia, came over from Brown in 1993 to take over the reins here in Charlottesville. One of the most respected coaches in all the game.
Here's the Dodge attempt, a shot and a score. A second goal by Danny Glanning, who is all ACC, and he has come out on fire.
Well, you can't give Virginia opportunities off of mental mistakes, and that's exactly what Delaware did. They went off sides, possession back over to Virginia, and Danny Glanning just uses his frame, all 6'2 of them, to come around the goal, uses his strength just to plant his feet just ever so much to get leverage on the shot, and a beautiful move at X point behind and just rockets that thing past Tommy Scheer, falling away from the goal, still got that mustard on it, shows you the strength of Glanning.
Face off won by Smith. He feeds in close. And no shot immediately taken by Delaware. Zuiderhavens has it now. Adam Zuiderhavens, former junior college player at Herkimer out of Corning, New York, still in possession of the ball. He comes in close and he misses at point blank range.
That's very indicative of the Delaware attack, as a beautiful ride produces a loose ball. These guys are dodge first, shoot second, and then feed third. Not a lot of Delaware goals are assisted.
Now we get a push against Delaware, so the ball will go over to Virginia. Cavaliers out to a 2-0 lead here in the opening 2.5 minutes of play.
If you're Delaware, you've got to step up and make a play here on the ride, or else defensively get a stop and get that ball back in the stick of your offense. Try to break the ice here and get off the schneid as Virginia's up 2-0.
Here's Rubio. He got the feed from Will Barrow. On the near side now, it will be Billings from British Columbia. Out he goes to Thompson. Has the ball poke checked away, but he regains possession. Now bounce shot deflected by the goalie Scheer. It'll roll out of bounds, and possession will remain in the hands of Virginia.
Nice save by Scheer as he fights off the shot from Jack Riley, as we get a good look at Garrett Billings there. Really the forgotten man of this tremendous duo of Glanning and Rubio. And honestly, if it weren't for Matt Donowski and Zach Greer about 3.5 hours from here down in Durham, I think all the press clippings would be about Rubio and Glanning, this excellent tandem that resides here in Charlottesville.
Carroll to Rubio. Now they work it on the near side here to Billings from British Columbia. A couple of British Columbia players in this game. Here on the move and slipping down is Drew Thompson, and he is slow to get to his feet. Thompson is down and hurt as Delaware comes in transition.
Nice job by Virginia, though, even with Towson down.
Delaware gets their first score of the game.
What a rocket shot by Tim Fuchs. Excuse me, number 38 for Delaware. That's Brian Calabrese, one of the captains of the Blue Hen defense. And he's going to get a stick check. It's unusual to check a defenseman's stick as the goal scorer, but just a rocket shot in transition. Virginia did a good job of getting back, but with Thompson on the ground, it was a 6-on-5, and Calabrese just steps in and puts a bullet past Kip Turner, high to high, non-stick side, stings the upper 90 of that net, and Calabrese, his second goal of the season. That is huge as Delaware gets on the board.
He is out of the high school lacrosse powerhouse, West Genesee, suburb of Syracuse. Brian Calabrese, no relation to Sean Calabrese, who also plays for Delaware. It is a 2-1 game.
Here we see the battle at the faceoff square. Alex Smith does a great job of just holding it up. And we talked about the wing play, and that's an excellent ground ball by Drew Turner coming up and picking it up after Smith was able to keep Fosnock at bay and get possession for the Blue Hens.
Now Vince Giordano behind to Zuiderhavens. Substitutes coming on for Delaware.
One thing about Delaware, too, Dave, they have a tremendous amount of left-handed offensive players. We talk about Rubio and his left-handed prowess, but Delaware has about 6 or 7 guys who can score, and they're all left-handed.
Matt Mione's on the move now, checked out of the play by Barrow, and Zuiderhavens operates from behind. Going against Smith. Double team, still holding. Up top, off the stick of Kaminsky, and out of bounds, so the turnover, and Virginia gets it.
Tough break for Delaware, the second midfield unit on the field for the Blue Hens. They'll run three, and just a simple exchange pass up at the top of the box goes awry. Possession over to Virginia. Delaware right now, they've had 2 mental mistakes, and 1 cost them earlier a few minutes ago. We'll see if they can thwart this attempt by Virginia.
The goalie, Kip Turner, comes out about 30 yards to help out on the clear. Now they get it into the box and back it out of the box. Steve Giannone, number 5, giving it off. They'll go behind to Rubio right now. Rubio, played by the defender there for Delaware.
That's Rob Smith. First team All-Colonial Athletic Association pick, and we're going to have a warding off call against Ben Rubior. So possession will go over to the Delaware Blue Hens.
Scher is going to put it in play, and he goes to Rob Smith.
There we see the turnovers, three apiece for Delaware and Virginia.
Coming back to play, and now is Dan Deckelbaum, the midfielder, splits the defense and gives it back to the big stick. Now they get the cutter, Jordan Hall, in close. That would have been a catch and shoot opportunity. Delaware doing a good job in pursuit of these ground balls. That was Curtis Dixon who kept it alive. Here's Delaware's opportunity, Zuna Havens. He backs it off.
I'm really impressed with Delaware and their riding right now.
Oof. Jordan Hall, number 20, another of the British Columbia players. And Delaware's going to keep it.
I think that ball had a lot of muscle and it goes over the cage. Zuderhavens could have been well served to maybe take a step above the plane of goal line extended to try to increase his angle. But Zuderhavens, he is one of those five players for the Blue Hens, all Colonial Athletic Association teammates with Brett Queener, the winning goaltender for Albany in the game that was on ESPNU that saw Albany knock off Loyola and punch their ticket to Princeton next weekend in a quarterfinal matchup against Cornell.
J.J. Moran exchanging with Dan Deckelbaum. This is Moran, starts his dodge, goes to the right hand. Now they'll work it from behind. Again, it goes up top. Deckelbaum, played by Barrow, stays alive and in possession. They'll back it out and they'll do it again.
Deckelbaum, a huge midfielder, 6 foot, 205 pounds, reminiscent of John Reese.
Got the step there on Barrow. Here's a low to high shot off of Jordan Hall's stick and back up nicely. Dixon back there for Delaware. The Blue Hens playing with confidence, looking to tie, and they do. Adam Zuderhavens out of Corning, New York, has tied the game at the 8:35 mark.
Zuderhavens, the junior college All-American at Herkimer a couple of years back, won a national title for that program. His 33rd goal of the season, just a great cut across the face of the defense, and he takes the feed from Giordano, feels the pressure. The defender for Virginia tried to go over the head. Zuderhavens sensed that pressure, tucks his stick, and just puts a rocket shot right past Kip Turner. Delaware right now, after some jitters early on, is really starting to get into this game.
Again, it'll be Fosnacht on the right, Alex Smith on the left, and the top faceoff man in the country wins it. He has it checked out of his stick, but it's recovered by Manny. He goes down, loses the ball, ground ball, and let's see who's got it. Delaware really tenacious on these ground balls. And for the moment, it's Drew Thompson, number 12, in possession.
And that last goal, as we see a jump out of the box.
Beautiful jump.
Great job by Calabrese, who's all over the place in the early going.
He surprised Rubier on that one. But now Delaware playing with confidence. You can see it in their movement.
A lot of pep in their step, a lot of energy. And there's Curtis Dixon. Credit him with that last goal, with that great ride and getting the ground ball back to extend the possession for his team and give Zuderhavens and Giordano that opportunity to scorch the twine like they did.
Martin Cahill now on. Delaware using lots of players, keeping their legs fresh. Here's Kaminsky. Delaware will play deliberate at times and then speed it up, changing tempos.
It's about 70, 73 degrees here at Kloeckner with a strong wind, strong breeze, so it's not incredibly warm here.
Here's the other Calabrese, Sean, no relation. Again, back behind Giordano. Tough angle, it's in! Tough angle shot, and he surprises Kip Turner.
That's the perfect adjective to describe this goal, Dave. Surprised, as it looked like Giordano was looking to feed. Here we see the exchange pass to point behind. Giordano head up all whole time, plus in pretty good defense. And Giordano just steps away from the pressure. He'll see it. He'll step away right there to establish just enough space between he and Clausen to put a nice bounce shot past Kip Turner. And the All-American from Severn normally has those saves. I don't think he's yet to come up with one in the early going here as Delaware takes the lead 3-2.
Alex Smith did what he could after that ball looked like it was going to Virginia. He committed a violation, so the Cavaliers get it. Bauer has it at the midfield line. 3-2 Delaware. They've scored three unanswered goals. Bauer now sends over to Jack Riley.
And it's interesting, we talked about tempo. Delaware has come out and has really attacked this Virginia defense. They have not been bashful in any way, shape, or form.
Lanning goes to the left hand. He feeds in close, tie game. Beautiful job by Riley as he caught it, turned around, and he beat the goalie, Tommy Scher. We have a 3-3 game.
Nice job by Gladding, taking advantage of the mismatch here. As we'll see in the replay, he gets matched up on a short stick defensive midfielder for the Blue Hens. Not bad defense, turns him back, but because Gladding's such a deft dodger, everybody on the crease was looking to slide, and they didn't pay attention to Jack Riley sipping behind the Blue Hen defense. Beautiful catch and turn, nice shot. Jack Riley, his 15th of the season off of the feed from Danny Gladding.
Well, Delaware came into this game averaging 12 goals a game, Virginia just under that. And we've got a very offensive game here in ideal conditions.
There we see Smith, he jumps again. So possession back over to Virginia. And Drew Thompson is checked back into the contest, so he is okay after that injury a few minutes ago.
We haven't seen Rubier take too many shots yet. Right now it's Gladding feeding Thompson. A slip down earlier that led to a fast break, a transition goal for Delaware. It looked like he was hurt momentarily. Here's Carroll outside on the move. Brian Carroll has got a brother, Kevin, on the team. Sends it back.
If you're Delaware, you want to make Virginia work for some shots. They really haven't had any extended defensive stands. All of Virginia goals have come pretty quickly after they've gotten possession, but nice defense behind. We're going to have a flag down.
Drew Turner on Thompson. They exchange pleasantries. The flag flies. What's it all about?
It looks like Hans Wittelsberger, referee Hans Wittelsberger, is going to get a slash call against number 33, Drew Turner. Here we see the check. That's clean. Right there is the slash across the chest of Drew Thompson. So Turner will spend up to 1 minute in the sin bin for that slashing penalty. The first check was clean that dislodged the ball, Dave, but anytime you check a man across the chest like that without hitting stick or his gloved hand, you're going to spend a minute in the box, and Hans Wittelsberger right on top of that call.
So we get our first look at the extra man opportunity. The offense of Virginia, they're looking to take the lead here. Thompson to Carroll. And now briefly on the stick of Rubior. Sort of been a decoy in the early going. Let's see if they set him up here in this extra man opportunity. Billings. And now it's Carroll. And here is Rubior. I don't know if he's had a shot yet.
A ton of motion here for Virginia's extra man. A 3-2-1 into a 2-3-1 with a very high and active crease.
Now they go the other way and a beautiful save by Tommy Scher. They reversed it and Scher played it.
Scher, the junior out of Mount St. Joseph High School in Baltimore, read that one all the way. Popcorn, as he was able to stop it, pop it to himself and get the ball out, but now Virginia has to get it into the box.
They toss the ball high in the air, and it's taken away by Virginia, and they pop it in the air as well. And now here comes Smith back for Virginia. Rick Smith feeds it down. He'll go behind with the ball in the stick of Gladding. Now Rubior. He feeds it up top, shot, save again by Scher. And Crowther Washburn has it.
Last three shots for Virginia have been saved by Scher. I think that first stop that he was able to fight off has really done wonders for his confidence.
Good job by Virginia as they deflected the clear. Here's the feed to Rubior, and his shot is wide.
Taking a page out of the Delaware attack book, tenacious ride by Virginia, gets possession back after the Scher save.
Ball back in play quickly. Gladding slips down, played by Crowther Washburn. He goes in and he scores. What a move by Gladding. His second goal of the game, and Virginia's back on top.
Danny Gladding with 3 points so far in the game on a 2 goals and an assist. And this is what he excels at. He likes getting his man at point behind that X position and just making juke moves back and forth before deciding to come with that left hand. And he does a great job of feeling the pressure on his backside, extends his stick, and just rolls it underneath of Tommy Scher. 2 goals today so far for Danny Gladding.
What a game of spurts. Virginia got the first two. Delaware the next three. Virginia's answered back with two. And Deckelbaum controls the faceoff for Delaware. Now the Blue Hens look to tie it up.
So much these days, lacrosse fans complain about the lack of speed and scoring and offensive aggressiveness. Those people who are complaining about are not saying a word right now. The first 11 minutes of this contest has been absolutely outstanding.
Dixon to Deckelbaum now, J.J. Moran. Doesn't have an angle for a shot. He'll send it to Giannone. Yeah, Giordano, that is. Now back it goes to Moran. He feeds. And Dixon looking for his shot. It was a weak attempt and played easily by Turner. He outlets it in the middle now to Steve Giannone. Giannone.
Not a good decision by Dixon that time. Got into the heart of the defense. So Virginia, you got to make a decision. Feed or shoot. He did neither, and Virginia was able to dislodge that ball.
Ribior has been very patient. Landing with two goals, has it now. Sends back behind. This is Billings. And now here's Rubio. Will he make a move? He'll try it. Will he get a shot? It's going to be doubled, but he gets rid of it first. Good defense being played out there by Delaware. And they're going to come away with a ground ball. We get a procedure call. It'll give it to Delaware.
Looks like it's going to be playing with the free hand off the stick against George Hughley of the Virginia Cavaliers. A little bit of hiccup right there as he could not corral that ground ball. And the great defense of J.J. Moran able to keep it hot. And he wins possession off the procedure.
Giordano with it now as they go behind. And they mishandle the ball on the back line. And Virginia's going to get it.
Well, when you go up and down like this, the way these two teams have been going, it opens you up for mistakes. And it also can tire you out.
Barrow feeds Ricky Smith, the big stick, fake going behind his back. Now he'll look to dump it off and get back.
Smith, one of the best defensemen in the country, one of the best long poles at getting the ball up in transition. He has three assists on the year, and he can be a real catalyst for this Virginia fast break offense.
Billings sends it outside. George Hughley on now. Hughley is going to be joined by Steve Giannone, who comes back on. Giannone starts his drive. Giannone, played by Manny, number 13.
Virginia real spread here, a 2-2-2 offense.
Billings comes in close. The ricochet is pulled down. We have a crease violation, and Delaware is going to get it. Or do we?
It's Garrett Billings came inside and was drilled after that shot opportunity. Here we're going to see it. Billings gets inside, and then right there is the push. That could have even been called a cross check as Drew Turner came in and laid the boom on Garrett Billings.
Now Billings sending it behind to Gladding. He's already got two goals. Played by J.J. Moran. The stick flies out of there. The ball goes in the air, and it's mishandled. Taken down by Giannone. Giannone feeds it. Spinning move being made here by Gavin Gill. Extra attacker in the game. Reserve attacker, that is. Manny takes it down now for Delaware. A little wild happenings there.
Well, I tell you, not only was the stick helicoptered out of the hands of Danny Gladding, but it was more like a stealth bomber. That thing was so high up in the air here at Klockner Stadium, and a good job by Delaware to get that ground ball.
Turner had it momentarily. Now the Blue Hens work from behind. Adam Zuiderhaven's number 7. He's got a goal here in the first quarter. 4-3. Virginia as we approach the 1 minute mark.
It's been a couple of minutes since Delaware has had an extended possession, so we'll see how aggressive they are here at attacking the goal. They're going to go right away.
Sean Calabrese looks for the right hand shot, doesn't have the angle, slips down, keeps the ball.
Delaware right now in a 1-3-2 with three guys just picking and repicking, scissor cutting on the crease, trying to create an opening while at the same time staying out of the way of Zuiderhaven's as Ricky Smith is just working over the senior out of Corning, New York.
Here comes Kaminsky, trying to get a step to the right side. Trying a left, coming back right, shooting, scoring. Tying the game at 4. Good effort by Kevin Kaminsky.
Great shot by Kaminsky, who not only crosses up the long pole defender with a series of moves and great footwork, but he also handcuffs Kip Turner, as Turner looks like he was confused as to whether or not to step to the ball. Here you see the footwork, crosses up Timms, he slips, and he puts a shot where Turner either has to step with his body or get his stick over. He does neither, And that's great placement by Kevin Kaminsky, his 16th goal of the year, first this afternoon.
Freshman out of Wallingford, Pennsylvania. We're into the closing 23 seconds of the first quarter. Virginia has it. With it is the faceoff man, Adam Fasnacht. Trailing check attempt, unsuccessful. Down goes the Virginia player. We're down to 10 seconds to go. And Delaware comes away with it. Do they have time to score? They whip it to the midfield area. 33 is Turner. He feeds it in close. Delaware looks for the lead. They will not get a shot away. And time has run out in the first quarter. What an opening 15 minutes here in Charlottesville. Our score, the Fighting Blue Hens of Delaware 4 and the defending national champion Virginia Cavaliers 4. The winner of this game to face the winner of Maryland and UMBC. That's coming up after this one on ESPNU.
We've all seen them. The makeup artist. The dedicated investor. Mr. Change Your Pants While Driving. Multitasking doubles your risk of an accident. Do it a little less, and now Allstate will give you a bonus. Cash off your renewal bill for every 6 months you don't have an accident. Part of your choice auto, only from Allstate. It's time to make the world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
What's the matter, Mom?
Well, I'd love to have new floors in here, but I don't know how to tell your dad.
Dad! Mom wants new floors!
Come into the Home Depot today and get professional carpet installation for your whole house for the special price of just $99. Getting luxurious carpet is easier than ever with this exceptional offer from the Home Depot. Don't miss it.
You hungry again?
Give me the usual, raw.
That's all I got here. These are tough, right?
Yeah.
It's okay, Scratch. This guy's good. Enjoy. Schlesinger raw, made to be pounded.
I was responsible for bruises, abrasions, and a few stitches. After I graduated, I became a nurse.
It only seemed fair.
There are over 380,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of them will be going pro in something other than sports.
Start of the second quarter, Delaware and Virginia knotted up at 4 apiece. It's been a terrific game. As you look at Bob Schillinglaw, the longtime head coach of the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championship action continues on ESPNU tonight. The UMBC Retrievers face the number 7-seeded Maryland Terrapins in first round action. That's after us tonight at 7:30 here on ESPNU, presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Second quarter face, same folks involved. Adam Fasnacht and Alex Smith, the best in the country. He wins it, and here he comes. And it's saved by Turner. Smith paid the price after the shot as he was spilled.
Nice save by Turner. High to high, Smith off of the faceoff. And here we see a score update from Chapel Hill, Dave. Navy up 4-3 after one, so it looks like they've got a track meet in Chapel Hill, much like we do here in Charlottesville.
Yeah, we were there yesterday. Unfortunately, they could not play because of weather conditions, but we're certainly enjoying being here at Charlottesville. Dave Cohen along with Mark Dixon. Virginia and Delaware tied at 4. Virginia is in white, looking to jump in front here. And the shot is wide. Perhaps Sherry got a piece of that. Virginia will keep it.
You're looking at this game, you start to think, can these teams withstand this pace? As we look at the stats for the first quarter, shots relatively even, faceoffs almost 50-50. Delaware winning that ground ball battle, and I think that's really helped them jumpstart their offense and get some scoring opportunities.
Here's a hard bounce shot, and it's played nicely by Scheer. He has been Tommy on the spot. He outlets it in transition. Here come the Blue Hens. They feed in close. Oh, he rolled it in with a backhand. What a shot. Curtis Dixon. And that was all made by the big stick that ran it upfield in transition after the save by Scher.
What a great job by Scher as he makes the initial save. It's tough on grass. He actually adjusted his body and his stick to make that save. It was a nasty worm burner. Here we see Brett Manny then coming up, leading the break. Gets it inside to Curtis Dixon, and Dixon knows if he turns around right-handed, he's going to go right into the check of Ken Clausen. So he just drops his stick and rolls it past Kip Turner. Eyes in the back of his head, Curtis Dixon, as he gets the score.
This time the faceoff won for the moment by Virginia, then knocked free. Alex Smith, who's an excellent ground ball man, leads the country in ground balls, as well as faceoffs. Delaware has it, stolen away on the outlet pass. Now here comes Smith, the big stick, laying it off. Here's a shot and a save again by Tommy Scher.
Scher is seeing the ball extremely well. He's reacting very aggressively. And look at his outlet passes. They're right on the money.
How about the transition? Winding up, faking. Now coming in, a diving shot and a score. What a goal again by Dixon.
Are you kidding me?
How did he keep his balance on that? He knew he was going to stumble. And he found another gear.
Well, Michael Watson and Doug Knight, Michael Watson in particular, made a living of going airborne here at Kloeckner back in the late 90s. And here we see Dixon fakes the shot. His defender ducks, gets a check in, and Dixon has enough strength as he's parallel to the ground. He shot this while he's in the air. Look at it. He's in the air and shoots it. Beautiful placement, has just enough mustard on it to beat Kip Turner offside. Curtis Dixon having an outstanding first half thus far for the Blue Hens.
And the streaks continue. As we said, Virginia got the first two, Delaware the next three, then Virginia had two, and now Delaware has had three goals. Unanswered, the biggest lead of the game for Delaware at 6-4. Delaware has possession after a violation. They look to go up by three now. Giordano to Adam Zuiderhavens. Delaware playing with confidence. You could sense it in that first quarter.
Bob Schillinglaw said during the week their backs have been to the wall for a number of games now, so this is nothing different from them, and they realize they're the underdog, but they feel like they're a talented bunch that can make some things happen.
Speedy Sean Calabrese still has the ball. Now they pack it in front. He feeds up top. Shot Kaminsky, saved by Turner.
Big stop for the senior. Saw that one all the way and gobbles it up, and here comes a transition for the Cavaliers. This thing has been end-to-end all afternoon.
Giannone feeding Rubier. Rubier has had maybe one shot, if any.
He's been limited in his touches and his looks. Again, he's still hobbled by that knee injury somewhat, so his explosiveness, he's almost 100%, but all the explosiveness we've seen during the season has not been on display thus far in the first half.
George Ugly has it now for Virginia. Ugly, a freshman out of Chevy Chase, Maryland. Here's Rubier again. He beats his man but draws the double team. Look how Delaware slid over and took away the angle. And that shot is wide. Backed up by Virginia, they'll keep it.
You can definitely see Delaware's defensive strategy. Quick slides on Rubier.
Nice goal on the individual effort by number 9, Dan Gladding, his third goal of the game. And he cuts the Delaware margin to 1 at 6-5.
We talked about it earlier, and this is the third goal of the afternoon for Danny Gladding from virtually the same move. He loves to get you started on the restart. Straight bull dodge, speed right past his defender. Delaware has been sliding early to Rubier. They may have to make an adjustment and start sliding much earlier to Danny Gladding as he's torched them for three scores here in the first half.
And yes, it's confirmed. Rubier has had only one shot, and we're a minute into the second quarter, 3 minutes into the second quarter. Delaware has control after the faceoff. Manny gets it to Dixon. He's been the star for the last couple of goals. Tries to split the D. He does. And that ball was checked out of his stick from behind. Rolled weakly into Turner's stick, and now in transition, here come the Cavaliers.
Good patience by Timms with the trail check. And a flag is down as Delaware steps off sides on the tenacious ride. Number 4, Giordano. So now Delaware will play defense with 7 defenders taking advantage. They already got a flag down. They can't get any worse unless they slash or another type of personal foul.
Virginia has it. They'll keep possession until we get the whistle, and now the offsides violation will be assessed.
And just a Giordano that time trying to make a play through that last check-in. And what you normally teach your attackman, if you see the guy's numbers and you really don't have a chance to get him from the side or make a clean check on his stick, just let him go, because you're either going to end up slashing him in the back or going off sides with your momentum carrying you over midfield due to the check. That's what happened to Giordano. Possession and a man-up opportunity now for Virginia.
And the Cavaliers now look for the equalizer. They trail it 6-5. Again, Rubior, who has the knee brace on his right knee, has had only one shot. He is the All-American, the Tuorton Trophy nominee. Nice play out at the defense by Calabrese. And he feeds it up ahead. The big sticks doing the job. They may have a scoring opportunity in the shorthanded situation, and instead it's Virginia coming back, but we'll get a whistle.
Timeout called by Delaware right before the Wahoos made a Drew Turner sandwich out of number 33 for the Blue Hens. So a heady timeout call for Bill Schillinglaw, saving possession for his team.
So we've got 10:22 to play here in the second quarter, and it's Delaware leading Virginia 6-5 in this opening round game.
Amazing.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Hey, you want a ride? It's okay. Sorry. We're sorry.
Sorry, buddy.
Sorry, buddy.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
Well, you may be surprised at the score, but Delaware has come to play, and they lead the national champions 6-5 early in the second quarter. Don't forget, the NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships continue on ESPNU next Saturday with two quarterfinal games, Georgetown against Johns Hopkins, and Albany takes on Cornell. Games are noon and 3 Eastern time. The NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Those games next Saturday at noon and 3.
How about the different roads that those four teams took to get to Princeton? Georgetown and Hopkins, overtime wins against Notre Dame and Princeton. And of course, Albany and Cornell just really getting things done against Loyola and Towson, making their stamp and solidifying a spot in the quarters next weekend up in Princeton on ESPNU.
Vincent Giordano exchanging with Adam Zuiderhavens, who fakes the pass. Now he gets it back to Giordano. Up top they come, and Jordan Hall took his eyes off of it and lost it. The battle is on at midfield. Hall goes across to play it. Run down for the moment by Rubior. Ladding is trying to get possession. He lost sight of it. He was checked off the play, and Delaware's intensity and tenacity on those ground balls really helping them out in this contest. Shear is out.
This game has been physical. It's been aggressive. It's had a number of very hard, legitimate, clean lacrosse hits. Delaware is on fire right now emotionally, and Virginia's had a difficult time matching the intensity of the Blue Hounds thus far.
Again, it's Giordano. He'll settle down the team for the moment. Jordan Hall sends it back outside to Deckelbaum. And on the far side, there's J.J. Moran. Now Dixon, the offensive star so far. This is where Delaware again is changing the tempo and the pace. Now they go. Giordano lost the handle. Down to play it is Barrow. And here again is the ground ball action by Delaware.
Nice over the head check by
getting it to Deckelbaum.
Nice over the head check by Ricky Smith, but again, Delaware all over the GBs, picking it off with its grass surface here at Klockner Stadium.
Zuiderhavens off a tough angle, deflected out there. And It's another ground ball. Dixon has it. Dixon gives it up. Well, he is resourceful, isn't he?
Curtis Dixon is a tough player holding on to that ball under the intense pressure of Clawson and Kelly. And now Virginia's able to get it out of his stick, pick up the ground ball.
Smith gives it to Barrow. Barrow will take a couple of steps. Smith goes down. We have a delayed call coming up. Barrow works the left-handed shot, and it's wide. And now we'll get the call. It'll go against Delaware.
It's going to be an illegal body check against Delaware as Ricky Smith brought that ball across midfield, gave it up, and then was drilled up high in the helmet area after he gave it up. So Virginia will have another extra man opportunity here. And we talk about the intensity and the aggressiveness of Delaware. You have to learn how to channel it. And that time, the Delaware defender was just a little too ambitious as we look at Virginia. 32% for the season, but 0-2 today.
Extra man opportunities. Virginia looks to tie. Nearing the midway point of the second quarter, Rubior has only one shot. Here comes Virginia going counterclockwise for the moment. And Rubior has it in his stick, and he deals it back outside to Thompson. Lost ball by Billings, taken away by Delaware. On the move with it is Patrick Beal. Delaware using a lot of legs in this game.
Mental mistake as Billings just took his eye off of the ball. Such a fundamental, basic principle, but a lot of players are guilty of just not following it to their stick.
Manny,
turnover to Delaware.
Excuse me, Mark. Manny comes on, number 13 for Delaware. They mishandled the ball offensively, but the ball's on the ground, and Delaware's been so good. And once again, the Blue Hens are in there battling, the fighting Blue Hens. And we get a whistle to stop play.
Loose ball push as Ricky Smith pleads his case to the official, asking for a push with possession.
Carroll now headmans Thompson coming on the field. Started his dodge, but couldn't go anywhere. Rubior has it. Under 7 minutes to go, Delaware leading at 6-5. We're in the second quarter.
The pace over the last couple of minutes has settled down somewhat.
Thompson had the first goal of the game for Virginia.
He likes this matchup against Manny. He'll look to take him behind and invert and try to beat him off the dodge, but also have a cutter going to the pipes.
It's played man for man by Manny. Didn't get any help that time. Rubier is coming back to set the pick. Now they deal it up top to Carroll. He's got some shooting room for the moment. Again, it's Ben Rubier. Little hesitation. Now he goes to the right hand. He is left-handed, trying to work that way, and Billings lost the handle.
I tell you, that's the second or third time this game, second time in a row, that Billings has misjudged the handle on an exchange pass.
And he goes down. He slips. He gets up. Just gets it to, well, intended for Gladding, and he misplayed it at the back line. Kind of an unforced error, but Delaware is dictating the tempo.
They really are, and both defenses have been very aggressive, straight up man-to-man for both of these defenses thus far in the game. Virginia sloughing off a little bit more than Delaware is, but Delaware is just pushing the perimeter, laying extreme checks. There we see the turnovers, 12 for Delaware and 10 for Virginia. But you're right, Dave, they are dictating the tempo right now in this contest.
They even look like they're not afraid to take a penalty just to lay a little lumber.
Yeah, you know, they're not going to back down. I mean, I'm sure Delaware, they've got the attitude. Everybody in the world expects us to lose this game. We've got nothing to lose here this afternoon against the Blue Hens.
Oh, he didn't know whether to pass or shoot, and he just lost the handle on that. Losing it there was Chris Hitchborn, who was in the game for the first time.
Well, there you see, it was an I beg your pardon kind of move.
Will Barrow, maybe the fastest player in college lacrosse, has the ball now. He deals it to Rubior.
Looks like Virginia right now saying, settle it down. Let's get our matchups. Let's get our proper personnel. There we see Barrow. Huge goal against Hopkins earlier this year as a flags down.
A couple of flags down and a shot that's wide off the stick of Barrow.
We've got an illegal procedure call against Delaware here. Referee Hans Wittelsberger giving the signal to the bench. Technical foul, 30 seconds. I think Delaware may have had too many men on the field at some point. That prompted the flag to come down. There we see a back check, two back checks against Will Barrow, but that was after the flag had come down to signify the illegal procedure call against the Delaware Blue Hens.
And really, one of the stories of this game continues to be Ben Rubier not being a factor offensively. Again, Virginia looks to tie.
They're in that 2-3-1, quick ball movement, quick cuts. They just basically rotate over and fill to always stay in that 2-3-1, but a lot of motion and high crease.
That would have been wide, I believe. And it ricocheted back across the line like an offensive rebound. Virginia keeps possession.
Here we see the shot from Rubior.
Another ball misplayed out at the point as we came back.
Rubior's shot hitting off the iron, unlucky for him.
And that shot is wide. Now Virginia off the mark on their shooting.
I tell you what, Cher has made a couple of saves of the real nice variety, and he might have the Virginia shooters thinking.
Not that time, however. The equalizer. It is goal number three of the game for Danny Gladding, an all-ACC player, sophomore from Bethesda, Maryland. He had had only, well, one goal in the two games prior to this, but he's got three today.
Well, we see Gladding. He's had three from the left-hand side. Here he goes right, and just a sprint dodge, bulls his way past the defenders, and dunks it by Tommy Scher. Danny Gladding, his 31st of the season, his fourth today. He's come off the schneid in a big way for this Virginia offense.
Alex Smith has won all four faceoffs this quarter, and that one will go to Delaware on the violation.
So Virginia gets called for procedure, and the transition here.
And the shot, and that one's wide. Taken there by number 28, J.J. Moran.
Moran, Smith hustled to the box and was able to get off the field quicker than Fosnock was, and that prompted the transition right there as J.J. Moran had an opportunity right there on that 5-on-4 break.
Dixon has it now, sends to Zuiderhavens. Zuiderhavens goes to Giordano. Deckelbaum way outside. Now they go to Jordan Hall. Man from Surrey, British Columbia, gave it to Deckelbaum. He took his eyes off it. He gets it back. Will he shoot it? He does. And backed up there by Zuiderhavens.
Deckelbaum and Hall, both first team All-CAA in 2007. They've been quiet here today, but the attack for Delaware really getting the job done.
Dixon missing from in close. It's going to be run down there by Matt Kelly. Kelly being harassed from behind by Zuiderhavens. Double with Dixon. The ball's on the ground. Giannone has it.
Virginia just being hounded all over the field, but a great ground ball by the Cavaliers as the Dom Starship will take a timeout to talk about things.
3:20 to go in the second quarter, all tied at six. So it's been a game of spurts, the last two goals by Virginia's Danny Gladding, and this game is 6-6 with 3:20 to go in the first half.
To your dreams, got you on your way. With Citi's people and expertise, you have a partner to help you buy that house, start that business, plan a future. We all need a partner that helps turn dreams into realities. Citi, let's get it done.
Welcome back to the NCAA Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Maybe the best game of the weekend, 6-6 Delaware and the defending national champions, the Virginia Cavaliers, who are trying to make it three titles in 5 years under head coach Dom Starcia.
Yeah, Dom Starcia just had such a wonderful career here. 271 career wins between Brown University and the University of Virginia, third among active D1 coaches. And not to look too far ahead, Dave, because 2007, this is the greatest time of year for college lacrosse, but Dom Starcia has a recruiting class coming in next year that is second to none, highlighted by a duo from Huntington, New York, the Bratton brothers. So they might make you forget about your Syracuse boys, the Gates. We'll have to wait and see.
A lot of brother acts in this sport of lacrosse. Tom Starcher, by the way, was a college roommate of Ben Rubier's father, Matt Brown.
Virginia out of the timeout, a 2-3-1, working that ball around with a very high crease. And Danny Gladding has just feasted all over Delaware so far from those with those moves from behind.
Now they swing it to Rubier, and his shot is played by Scher, who saw that one all the way.
Delaware that time, Dave, slipped into a little bit of a zone, packed it in with Tommy Scher. So obviously they have confidence in their netminder. He's played a solid first half with several very nice saves. They dared Virginia to shoot it from the outside. Virginia took the dare.
Tommy Scher coming off a career-high 17 saves in the Colonial Championship, and the go-ahead goal right there for Delaware, and it's Rob Smith. How about that?
Rob Smith, the transfer from Georgetown, has really done a spectacular job coming to the University of Delaware and really solidifying this defense. Look at the face dodge and look at the strength and speed of Smith. Every defenseman's dream. You come in with a full head of steam, put that bounce shot past the goalie and find the back of the net. Rob Smith, great end-to-end action. His fifth goal of the season off of the save. And again, a nice outlet pass by Tommy Scher.
And again, Smith wins the faceoff. Can they strike again quickly? They get it even with a crease. Rob Smith, by the way, you mentioned a transfer from Georgetown, a fifth-year graduate student, so under the current NCAA rules, allowed to transfer and play immediately. And he just paid big dividends for Delaware.
Well, lacrosse is a lot different than college basketball and football. Oftentimes, when you have these transfer situations, the coach from the school where the scholar-athlete is coming from, the student-athlete is coming from, will always sign that waiver and not force a player to sit out a year. So there you see those quick turnarounds for these athletes.
Delaware looking to up their lead to two again. Big check. No flag flying. Minute and a half to go. Good job by Deckelbaum as he reached out to hole in the pass from Giordano. Up top now, it's Jordan Hall. Sooner Haven's on the far side. He's number seven. Virginia sagging back. Here's the dodge fake. Zuider Havens gets it to Dixon. He's got a couple of sensational goals. Now Deckelbaum and Zuider Havens.
Delaware almost looking like they want to play for the last shot here. We'll see if the referees force them to keep it in with the stall. We haven't had a need for that thus far in the contest, but the refs are looking at each other now.
Zuider Havens takes one on the head before he gets the shot away, and the laundry flies.
Looks like he's going to draw a holding foul against the Virginia defense. Virginia has been very quick all afternoon to go for those over-the-head checks. And Zuiderhavens that time ducks underneath and is able to draw the foul.
This may be the first extra man opportunity for Delaware coming up.
There we see Ricky Smith punches the sky over the head, but Zuiderhavens ducks it. And Ricky Smith corrals him up around the neck area. So there's the holding foul. And Delaware with another opportunity here to score another goal.
Number three, Bo Davis has come on for the first time. He's in the extra man offense. Delaware almost mishandled it. Also in there, 42, is DJ Whitlake. This is Davis.
Key here not to force anything if you're Delaware.
Davis cranks it up, but he doesn't shoot it.
Even if they can't score in the 30 seconds, they'll have another 20
Davis
before the half ends.
Davis again, Mark. And he fires it, and that's going to go back to Virginia. There was no backup.
Just what I was talking about. You don't need to force that. As number 24 for Delaware, Nick Lamonto was coming above goal line extended. He sacrifices the backup. Turner hustles Virginia ball.
Good pressure being applied by Hall and Zuiderhavens. And with 16 seconds to go, Delaware is going to get it back.
It's a withholding call against Max Pomper. He chested it. Possession of Delaware.
Zuiderhavens cranks. And that one is backed up. With 11 seconds to go, Delaware will have another chance. Quickly, they put it in play. Out it goes to Manny. Manny looks for the right-hand shot. It's wide. And again, Delaware keeps it. Under five.
Living dangerously with no backup there.
That shot is deflected. It'll roll out of bounds, and time has run out. Coming up on the Warrior Lacrosse Halftime Report, we'll have a feature on the Towardin Trophy finalists. We'll look at the brackets and break them down, and we'll have first half highlights and statistics. And there are a whole lot of highlights that you'll enjoy seeing again. So we've played two quarters here in Charlottesville, Virginia. Sensational lacrosse in the opening round. It's the Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens 7, the Cavaliers of Virginia 6. We'll be returning to Charlottesville, Virginia, right after these words here on ESPNU.
NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships exclusively on ESPNU. Just four more victories left to be crowned this year's champion. Anything less and the season is over. The championships continue with UMBC versus Maryland next on ESPNU. Weeknights, ESPN News keeps you current. Warm up with pregame analysis. Stay up to date with time live looks and its action on postgame. Weeknights starting at 7 only on ESPN News.
Years of fencing and 3 years of law school teach you a lot. For him, it's confidence. For me, it's pride. Go to NCAAstudent.org to find out how your child could become one of the many student athletes who go pro in something other than sports.
Homeowners, want to refinance and get cash? Countrywide has a great reason to do it now. A no-cost refi. It has no points, no application fee, no credit reporting fee, and no third-party fees, no title, escrow, or appraisal fees. Absolutely no closing costs, so you'll wind up with a lot more cash. Call now and ask for a no-cost refi. We're America's number one home loan lender, and no one can do what Countrywide can. Call 1-800-641-7136.
Dish Network Pay-Per-View gives you three easy ways to order your favorite movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment. It's as simple as pressing a button when you order Pay-Per-View by remote. If you're on the web, go to dishnetwork.com/PPV and order online. Or call 1-877-DISH-PPV to order by phone. All the latest movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment are right at your fingertips. And with three easy ways to order, nothing could be more convenient. Order Dish Network Pay-Per-View today.
And welcome back to the Warrior Halftime Report. It's halftime of our game here in Charlottesville, Virginia at Klockner Stadium between Virginia and Delaware. Dave Cohen along with Mark Dixon, and time now to talk about the finalists for the Towaradin Trophy awarded to the best player in college lacrosse. Let's look at the nominees, Mark, and begin first with Matt Danowski, the attack man from Duke.
Well, all five of these finalists, Dave, have shown up this weekend in a big way for their lacrosse teams, led by Matt Danowski, the odds-on favorite to take home the Heisman Trophy of lacrosse. Look at the moves, the quickness, the agility, the creativity that Matt Danowski possesses. If you try to shut him off, he will beat you on a dodge. If you try to slide too early, he'll beat you with a feed. Perhaps the most complete player in all of college lacrosse, Matt Danowski leading the Blue Devils to that number one seed.
Now we move to Albany. Frank Resiterich has put the Great Danes on the map.
Yeah, the big question, how has Albany had such a great season? And here's your Exhibit A, Frank Resiterich, the senior attackman of Hamburg, New York. He is a magician around the goal. Anything 8 yards and in, Resiterich will get a stick on it, and he'll put it in the back of the cage. The talented senior attackman leading the way for the Albany Great Danes.
Well, you've been looking at the junior lefty attackman, Ben Rubier, for the Virginia Cavaliers.
The leading scorer for the Virginia Cavaliers, defending national champions, a terrific left-handed player. He's tough, he's tenacious, and he can score with the best of them. He lights up the nets here at Klockner Stadium and nationwide. Ben Rubier leading the charge for this very talented Virginia national champion defending team.
It's not all about attackmen. We have a midfielder, Paul Rabel from Johns Hopkins.
The only one of two returning first-team All-Americans in 2007, the junior midfielder out of DeMatha High School in Gaithersburg, Maryland, saves his best for last. Two game-winning goals in overtime this year, wins against Princeton and Maryland. Here's the game winner against Princeton in early March at the Inside Lacrosse Face-Off Classic. An outstanding midfielder, Paul Rabel, leads the Johns Hopkins Blue Jays.
And there is a fifth nominee, Max Siebold from Cornell. He's positioned there on the right of the screen. Look at some of the numbers compiled by the likes of Danowski and the other players.
Yeah, Matt Danowski, 2 goals, 7 assists yesterday. And Max Siebold, the sophomore midfielder out of Cornell, a second-team All-American a year ago. I think it's safe to say that the number four seed, the number one ranked team in the country throughout the year, undefeated, being led by Max Siebold, a shoe-in for first-team honors in 2007.
Five nominees, one will be the winner. The Tewardin Award is college lacrosse's best player. We'll be back with more of the Virginia-Delaware game on ESPNU right after this. This halftime report is presented by Warrior, the means to dominate.
Doc, I can't stop. It's always one more hit, one more score. Kids stare at us in the street. I thought it would stop after college. But now at the MLL, people want to know how much they weigh and what they feel like. It's bad enough when I just had one. But with four, it's out of control.
Have you ever considered removing them?
Guys, we're out of here. She's a quack.
Oh, man.
Dude, you're addicted to what you're sticked to.
What's the matter, Mom?
Well, I'd love to have new floors in here, but I don't know how to tell your dad.
Come into the Home Depot today and get professional carpet installation for your whole house for the special price of just $99. Getting luxurious carpet is easier than ever with this exceptional offer from the Home Depot. Don't miss it.
Mom, that one's new motorcycle.
Boys!
Mama always forgave you, even when you did something wrong. Wouldn't it be nice to get that? In the real world, with accident forgiveness, part of your choice auto only from Allstate, your rates won't go up just because of an accident. Starting the day you sign up, it's time to make your world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
I run for a reason.
I run to win. I run because I can.
I run to stay in tune.
I run to kick your...
I run for me.
And welcome back to Charlottesville, Virginia, halftime, with the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens leading the Virginia Cavaliers by a score of 7-6. What a lacrosse game it has been. Hi again, everybody. Dave Cohen along with Mark Dixon. You couldn't ask for a more competitive game than what we have here. And this is indicative of this NCAA lacrosse tournament. You know, Mark, in 37 years, we've had seven different teams that have won it. But this year, we could have some new teams who are first-time winners, potentially.
Absolutely. Cornell leading the way. They have some national championships to their credit. But you also have Albany, the Great Danes, as we look at the bottom half of the bracket. Johns Hopkins and Georgetown looking for their second semifinal berth, their first since 1999. And then you've got Maryland and UMBC. UMBC playing some great lacrosse right now. The question is, how will their attack, which is high-powered, match up against that tenacious defense of Maryland? And Virginia, of course, their hands are full right now with the Blue Hens.
Georgetown, UMBC, and Delaware among those teams that have never won the national championship. And in the other half of the brackets, well, Duke is also a team that's highly regarded. They've never won.
And I think that's what you're talking about when you talk about the favorite to win the 2007 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Tournament. Duke has been there once in the national championship game 2 years ago in 2005. They'll look to get that national championship ring here in 2007. And you look at the bottom half of that bracket, Albany, they've never been past the first round. They venture into the quarterfinals. And Cornell, the number one team in the country, but the number four seed, they haven't been to a national championship game since the late 1980s.
In fact, the very last new team to win the national championship was Princeton way back in 1992. So one of those schools has a chance this year. As we check the score in the other game being played simultaneously, Navy leading North Carolina. That's a one-goal game at the end of three quarters.
You know, you knew it wasn't going to be the blowout that it was earlier in the year, Navy beating North Carolina 19-8. You knew it was going to be nip and tuck. And obviously at the end of three, 15 minutes to decide that close ball
and
game.
And Navy also in pursuit of their first national championship. So it could be the old standbys or the new kids on the block. We'll be back with more of this opening game. Delaware leading Virginia 7-6. We'll return to Charlottesville, Virginia right after this.
Run! No!
Hill, come in. Looks like the med school scouts are out early today.
There are over 380,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of them will be going pro in something else. Download the guide to bound students at NCAAstudent.org.
Homeowners, want to refinance and get cash? Countrywide has a reason to do it now. A must refi. It has points, no application fee, no credit reporting fee, and no third-party fees, no title, escrow, or appraisal fees. Absolutely no closing costs, so you wind up with a lash. Call now and ask for a must refi. We're America's number one home loan lender, and no one can do what Countrywide can. Call 1-800-641-7136.
Dish Network Pay-Per-View gives you three easy ways to order your favorite movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment. It's as simple as pressing a button when you order Pay-Per-View by remote. If you're on the web, go to dishnetwork.com/PPV and order online. Or call 1-877-DISH-PPV to order by phone. All the latest movies, sports, events, and adult entertainment are right at your fingertips. And with three easy ways to order, nothing could be more convenient. Order Dish Network Pay-Per-View today.
This halftime report is presented by Warrior, the means to dominate. Welcome back to Charlottesville, Virginia. Halftime, Delaware 7 and Virginia 6. Dave Cohen along with Mark Dixon. This is college lacrosse's absolute finest. Teamwork, but individual play as well.
I mean, is the only word I can use really to the first half. Up and down, fast pace. And right now, Delaware is beating Virginia at their own game.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights in the first half. Beginning in the first quarter.
Danny Gladden gets things rolling. Just a straight bull dodge from behind, left-handed. Virginia gets the early lead.
In fact, Virginia had a 2-0 lead. They looked like they were on their way, but Delaware turned things around.
Yeah, Ken Clauser, but Giordano gets a little bit of space and solves Kip Turner. And then we see another goal here by Delaware off the great dodge from up top. The second midfield unit contributing heavily for the Blue Hens.
Been a game of spurts.
And here we see Curtis Dixon. Look at the move and look at him airborne. Solves Kip Turner, slides it by him, and Delaware really gaining a lot of confidence in the second quarter. And here's where Delaware needs to make the big adjustment. Who can stop Danny Gladding for the Blue Hen defense?
Well, obviously, so far, Rubier has been held in check, but Gladding has more than picked up the slack.
Absolutely, and here we see the stats for the first half. Shots almost dead even. Faceoffs, Delaware dominating and also winning the ground ball battle. They're only winning the ground ball battle by three, but when you look at the score, and it's only a one-goal game, they are huge. But look at the man-ups. Virginia 0 for 4. You have to cash in. 30% is typically a successful rate. They are 0% so far here today. They're going to have to take advantage of some of those Delaware penalties in order to advance to the quarterfinals in Annapolis next weekend.
Danny Gladding, by the way, has hit all four of his shots. Rubior is 0 for 3. So that's the highlights and the statistical story of the first half. Delaware clinging to a one-goal lead on the road here at Virginia.
Amazing.
Curb appeal. Hate the color. Oh, honey, this is it.
What you got there is an infestation.
A lot of life happens in your car. Conoco, Phillips 66 and 76 quality ProClean gasolines help clean your engine as you drive.
The pink bat.
So you can focus on more important things. Conoco, Phillips 66 and 76 quality ProClean gasolines.
What's the matter, Mom?
Well, I'd love to have new floors in here, but I don't know how to tell your dad.
Dad! New floors!
Come into the Home Depot today and get professional carpet installation for your whole house for the special price of just $99. Getting luxurious carpet easier than ever with this exceptional offer from the Home Depot. Don't miss it.
Mom! That one's new motorcycle!
Hey. Did you know you could get paid to create the kind of games you love to play? With the right education, you could create cool characters, plan their missions, and decide the rules of play. Demand for video games is on the rise. That could mean more job opportunities. You could work as an animator, game analyst, or game programmer. Take your future to another level. Call Westwood College now.
Train online, 800-971-612. Call now.
Welcome back to the NCAA Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. The Fighting Blue Hens of Delaware have come with game today to Charlottesville, Virginia. Down 2-0, they rallied to take a lead at 6-4 after the game was tied at 6. They've regained the lead. That's where we are now, 7-6. And two of the key players we focused on before the game, Alex Smith doing his job, but Rubior has been held scoreless.
Yeah, Alex Smith has done a great job at the faceoff square. Rubior, the Tuareton finalist, yet to get on the score sheet. We'll see how the second half plays out here in Charlottesville.
Virginia's Fast Fasnacht wins the faceoff, and here come the Cavaliers. They need one to tie.
You talk to college coaches, as here's a shot by Thompson.
Thompson ties it up. Just like that, we have a tie game.
What I was about to say, Dave, is the first 3-4 minutes of a third quarter, especially in a game like this, is so indicative of who's going to win this ball game. And Virginia, you couldn't have asked for any better start. Thompson with just a sprint dodge, comes back, rocker step. His defender falls down, plants his feet, time and room. And just like he started the game, the senior out of Northport, New York, starts the third quarter this way. We've seen a lot of slippage happening out there in this contest. The field's not wet, the grass is extremely short. And there's another instance of it right there as Thompson gets his second of the afternoon.
Now the face, Alex Smith, leaves way for Jordan Hall. It's won by Delaware. Ball goes down. Took a good check, and now Virginia in transition, looking to regain the lead. We're tied at 7. Opening minute of the second half.
Two very different huddles coming out here for the third quarter.
Billings to Rubier if he gets hot.
Delaware, a lot of chest bumping, a lot of jumping up and down. High fives, a lot of energy. Virginia, just very cerebral, very subdued, just talking about things. We've been here before.
Ladding has not missed a shot. He's 4-for-4. Rubio's shot is wide. Wonder if he's getting a little frustrated with his shooting.
Well, credit Rob Smith. That time he was on the gloves. Rubio, not the best angle, but Smith has been shadowing Rubio all day. And the fifth-year senior has a goal for it as well.
Ladding gives it up outside. Thompson, now to Rubio. Started his move. And they'll back it out and do it again. This is Carroll. Ryan Carroll, freshman out of Towson.
Deco, we're special. Deco, we're special.
He sends it back out near midfield. And once again, they'll try to run their offense from out there. Thompson going right. Played by Hall. Hall takes the angle away. Here comes Gladding. Got a pick at the crease. Didn't use it.
But the pick was able to get the short stick matchup on Gladding as Delaware's out of whack defensively right now.
Now Gladding cranks, and there's Scher. He watched it all the way and gathered it in. Good job by the goalie, Tommy Scher.
The switch caused a little confusion in the Delaware defense, but Gladding didn't take advantage of it. Nice save again by Scher. He's been a difference maker in this ballgame.
Deckelbaum on the exchange, gets it back. Now they'll work it behind. Giordano sends it to Dixon, who had two sensational goals. Deckelbaum to the near side now to J.J. Moran. Moran back behind for Giordano. Here's the patience of Delaware. Now on the move is Deckelbaum, played by Carroll.
Deckelbaum lowering his head like a running back, bursting through a hole at the offensive line, trying to get to that Virginia goal.
Shooter Havens to Moran. Delaware shown the ability to play up-tempo or slow it down. Faking his hole. Zuderhavens stolen away, and here comes Virginia. In the middle of the field, it's Smith with a big stick, with operating room. He gives it up to Gladding, saved by Scher.
Well, the outstanding pickoff by the freshman Brian Carroll up to Smith. Gladding with a high-to-high shot, time and room. Scher read it all the way. Fast break, Delaware.
And here's a big stick, and it's pulled in by Kip Turner. He outlets it, maybe too far. Deckelbaum keeps it on the attacking half of the field.
Well, each shooter playing catch with the keeper. And the outlet pass goes awry that time, and Delaware wins possession back. And here's Adam Zuderhavens for the Blue Hens.
Rob Smith went back to the defensive side of the field, and on comes Martin Cahill.
What a great job today by the long poles and close defense of Delaware. Calabrese with a goal, several ground balls. Rob Smith
limiting Ben Rubior's touches, a lot of ground balls, and a goal. Those two gentlemen for the Delaware Blue Hens have played a great game thus far.
Dixon sends it way outside to Sean Calabrese, has come on along with Kevin Kaminsky. Kaminsky had a goal in the first half. Here's Sean Calabrese, played by Barrow. Thinks twice about shooting. 4 minutes into the third quarter, it is a 7-7 game. Zuiderhavens, what will he do? In front, touch, and score on a nice feed from Zuiderhavens to number 18.
That was actually number 48.
Number 48.
That's Curtis Dixon with his third goal of the afternoon. And just a beautiful look out front by Zuiderhavens. And here we see a little bit of ball watching. Ken Clausen, Dixon is behind him. Nobody accounts as Will Barrow tries to fill that backside. Curtis Dixon just steps in and redirects the feed from Zuiderhavens, the third on the afternoon for Curtis Dixon.
Very clever pass by Zuiderhavens. Alex Smith wins yet another faceoff. And Zuiderhavens pulls it down in the corner. Delaware holds on to the lead again by one goal. Look at Smith trying to dislodge the ball. He's hit him about four or five times legally. In close to Zuiderhavens, he backs off.
Well, it's no surprise Smith is a pure, aggressive, in-your-face, takeaway defenseman, and he'll throw every single check and be very aggressive in the meantime.
Sean Calabrese giving a hand signal.
He thinks he has a good matchup here against Barrow.
Fakes giving it to Kaminsky. Barrow's still sticking with him. Zuiderhavens is behind. Fake throwing it to him. Calabrese with a long possession here. Barrow still with him.
Dan Deckelbaum and Jordan Hall were the first team all-conference selections on the first midfield group for Delaware, but Bob Schillinglaw has to be incredibly pleased with the production he's getting from his second unit.
Zuiderhavens tried to go low, thinking maybe they couldn't see the angle of the shot. Smith comes away with it. Here comes the big pull. He's double-teamed. The ball is taken away. Crowther Washburn in there now.
It's amazing, Dave. It's almost like Virginia is clearing the ball in situations like that in quicksand. Delaware looks so much faster and so much more aggressive as Smith is in no man's land with three guys beating on him, no one coming up to give him help, and Delaware just being very aggressive on the ride once again.
Brian Calabrese goes across. Now Cahill comes into the offensive half of the field. Both Calabrese players were on. They're not related. Brian had a goal earlier. Here's Delaware. They have a one-goal lead. Player slips, maintains possession. Virginia will send it outside to Kaminsky.
Virginia has had two stops and failed clears on the last two stops that they've had defensively. And as a result, Delaware is able to keep that second group out there on midfield to give that first line a little bit more of a break.
Just get the feeling that Delaware is really dictating the way this game is being played.
It was one of the keys to victory for Virginia. And like we mentioned at halftime, Delaware beating Virginia at their own game at this point.
Zuiderhavens tried to backhand it. He's going to keep possession.
Good hustle that time by Kip Turner out of the goal for Virginia.
Delaware keeps it.
It's closest to the ball when and where the ball goes out of bounds. And that time the Delaware hustle saves them possession. Vincent Giordano beats it to the sideline to save for the Blue Hens.
Virginia had a two-goal lead at 2-0. Delaware had a two-goal lead at 6-4. Right now it's Delaware on top, 8-7. Tough angle shot. Who's going to have this one?
That's Virginia ball all the way as Hans Wittelsberger, the referee, emphatically signals white ball.
We've got an injured player. Sean Calabrese is down, and he is not getting up quickly. Sean Calabrese is the player who shot that from the tough angle, and he is in severe pain.
He's holding his head, it looks like, unless he's just trying to take his helmet off. He does have his hands over his head.
Looks like a leg injury, his left leg.
Yep. Okay. So maybe he's in pain and holding his head as the Delaware training staff attends to Calabrese. But when you look at the lay of the land, and if this is a leg injury, it segues nicely into the Ben Rubior situation. Rubio, of course, a left-handed attackman, as Bob Schillinglaw looks on. And he doesn't seem to have that burst, Dave, that he normally has. And as a left-handed player, your plant foot is your right leg.
You're looking at his left ankle. You hope for his sake it's only a cramp. It happened on the shot.
Here we see Calabrese coming around the goal And I think right there, he turns the ankle. And a lot of times a sprain, he steps away, nice shot. And right there, you can see that ankle just turn. And there you see the hustle by the Virginia defense beating Delaware to the sideline to win possession.
Calabrese, a sophomore from Rockville, Maryland. They're looking at the left ankle. Obviously not a cramp situation.
No. And I thought maybe it looked like he might have banged his head on the grass surface here.
Calabrese has been very, very active in this game, controlling the ball for long stretches.
Double in.
The best coach I ever had was my dad.
Practice. Practice. Practice.
He taught me that the fundamentals, together with hard work, make anything possible. And now it's time to teach others what my dad taught me.
Introducing Steve Nash's MVP Basketball, the only DVD program that makes back-to-back MVP Steve Nash your personal coach. You'll learn Steve's fundamental training secrets to give you a competitive edge on the court.
I don't think there's anybody in the NBA that doesn't any better than Steve Nash.
What an opportunity to have Steve Nash as your child's personal coach.
This program is about the fundamentals of basketball, and Steve Nash knows the fundamentals of basketball.
Order two-time MVP Steve Nash's MVP Basketball program for the low introductory price of only $29.95. Act now and you'll receive a second DVD, Steve's Team Play and Practice Organization, perfect for the parent coach, absolutely free. But it's not available in stores, so you must act now.
The injured player, Sean Calabrese, being helped off the field, looks like his day is done. And that's going to be a big blow for Delaware, if indeed that is how it plays out, because he's been very active.
Here we see it again. Good defense by Barrow. It's the left ankle, and I think it's when he lands off of that shot, he twisted the ankle underneath of him. And for anyone who's had a sprain before, that can be worse than a break or even a tear. So, a tough injury to Delaware, as he really is the leader of that second midfield unit, the quarterback, and really directing traffic out there for the Blue Hens.
Midway through the third quarter, it's Delaware leading Virginia 8-7. Virginia is the defending national champions. Delaware in only their fourth NCAA tournament ever. First time these schools have met since 99. There's the physical play by Delaware. Manny, and it's taken away beautifully by Delaware. Even on the ground, they're able to control the ball.
The 10-second count is on, and Virginia's doing a great job of keeping that ball on the turf. Now they win possession, but a nifty ground ball by Rob Smith, but excellent defense by the Cavs.
The net is open for the moment. Score! Giordano with a goalie coming out and hustling to get back off the unsettled situation. Giordano put it by Kip Turner, and it's a 9-7 Delaware lead.
Just great job by both teams getting after it in a big way. Here we see the loose ball. Look at Rob Smith, gooses it to himself, picks it up. Great defense by Kelly to stop his momentum. Thompson, a check for extra good measure. Ground ball picked up by Calabrese. More great ground ball work as Timms picks it up. But then Manny stands him up, and then the dive trail check by Rob Smith is what dislodges it out of Ricky Smith's stick. It goes to Giordano on the run for about 7 yards. Buries the bouncer past Kip Turner. Great action here at Klockner Stadium.
And it looks like Virginia's going to win this face. Thompson has it. Virginia trails by two. Rubior has not scored. Rubior has it now. He's had four shots in the game. Biggest lead again, 2 goals for Delaware.
And right now, Virginia in a situation, defending national champions on the ropes here in the third quarter, down by 2 goals. But this quick strike offense can get those goals back in a flash.
That last flurry resulting in the Delaware goal, just indicative of the way they've played all game. Carroll missing to the right, wide right, and Delaware's going to get it.
Interesting call, Hans Wittelsberger. Again, the rule is when and where the ball goes out. Danny Gladding was standing right next to the end line, but he was a whole half field away from that ball. So possession over to Delaware as Tommy Sharon, Rob Smith were closer when it went out of bounds.
Now the Blue Hens looking for their first three-goal lead of the game. With it for the moment there is Drew Turner, 33. Quickly they work it behind. Adam Zuiderhaven's number seven on the near side. Been a terrific game plan right from the outset by Delaware.
They've really just been jamming the ball down Virginia's throats, not backing off one inch. Pedal to the metal. They've taken the air out of the ball at certain occasions, like right now. They'll spin it around, look for a matchup, two-goal lead. But so many times in college lacrosse, you'll see a team that's not supposed to be winning a game, winning it late, and then they change up the way they play and take them right out of their game plan.
There comes Deckelbaum on the give, space and time, but no shot. Now the shot, and that one is not back up, so Virginia's going to get it.
What a great play by Ken Clausen, and he saw the windup up top by J.J. Moran and just sprinted to the end line as Giordano stayed flat-footed. Excellent hustle play from the freshman out of the Hill School in Pennsylvania.
Thompson slipping down, getting token pressure there from Giordano and Zuiderhavens. They get it down to Will Barrow. Now it's Rubio. Rubio sends it right behind. Working there is Gladding. He's got four goals in the game. Saved by Scheer. And he holds on. Now he outlets it to midfield, to Manny. Manny trying to get a step on his man. He gets it up ahead to Dixon. Dixon's had a couple of sensational goals. He looks for more. Behind the back. Ricochet in front. Raked on the ground by Hall. And it's still loose in front.
It's like a mass of humanity out there. About a six-car pileup. But Ken Clausen comes out with the ground ball.
Out of the scrum, it is Clausen. Outstanding freshman. He gets it up ahead to Gladding. Gladding trying to beat his man. He does. Check from behind. And Delaware comes away with it.
Danny Gladding with a great inside move. And the trail check was simply phenomenal by the Delaware defender to stop Gladding from having a one-on-one scoring chance.
Now Deckelbaum slows it down as he allows Kaminsky to come on. He'll play it on a bounce.
Patrick Beal that time with a brilliant trail check. Possession back over to Delaware.
Kaminsky sends it to Zuiderhaven. Zuiderhaven's and Giordano have been terrific in running this offense. Coming on now, Kyle Rotelli for the first time. Rotelli has it now. That's a famous name in college lacrosse.
His brother Chris Rotelli, Wartime Trophy winner, National Player, Midfielder of the Year, the first team All-American and National Championship for, champion for Virginia back in 2003.
Here's a quick shot and pulled in by Turner.
Creative, but not what you need in this situation from the Delaware offense.
9-7, Delaware leads Virginia. Here's Barrow. He's had one shot in the game. Ben Rubior outside. Get some room. Looking for the left-hand shot. It's loose in front, and it's shot high. And that was off the stick of Giannone.
What a...
You're watching first round NCAA action. Lacrosse men's tournament. Delaware in the dark jerseys leading Virginia 9-7 as we play late in the third quarter here in Charlottesville, Virginia. Dave Cohn along with Mark Dixon. Virginia, the number two seed in the tournament, defending national champions, but down by two goals on their home field.
We've seen Danny Gladding with two scoring opportunities from behind. We talk about an adjustment for Delaware. They do have a slide coming, but Tommy Scheer has taken a higher crease, a higher arc, stepping away from his pipe to cut down the angle of Danny Gladding. And the last two times, at least, that has worked to keep the sophomore out of Georgetown Prep from scoring his fifth goal of the afternoon.
Cahill is on with Kyle Rotelli, number 19. So Bob Schillinglaw continuing to get fresh legs in this game. Giordano cranks, and the ball is loose and run down. The ground ball scooped up by Delaware.
I mean, that's just a hustle play.
Cahill.
Cahill beats Pomper to that ground ball and saves possession for Delaware. You think back through the history of this tournament, Dave. First round upsets, if this holds true, I'm thinking about Notre Dame over Loyola years ago, back around 1998, I believe.
Pretty good effort by Cahill, just high on the shot. He had the angle, and another ground ball looks like it's going to be one, but now Virginia takes it away. Trail check attempt, one. Here's a second, unsuccessful by Kaminsky.
Good defense by Virginia. Trying to get back on the board here. They haven't scored a goal in about 12 minutes.
Billings sends it out now to Ugly, second team midfielder. Ugly is pursued there by Drew Turner. Now he puts it on the stick of Gavin Gill. Reserve attackman has come on. Here is Gladdy, 4 goals in the game. Ugly trying to work for some room.
It was actually 2000 in the first round.
Ugly again.
Notre Dame knocked off the Loyola Greyhounds in what probably is the biggest first round upset in the history of this tournament.
Rubier slips, regains. Even with the crease, they feed it outside. Deflected in close. Giannone couldn't get a stick on it. And Delaware takes it away.
Great recognition by Brian Calabrese. Again, Dave, he's all over the field, disrupts that pass.
Here comes Drew Turner. Turner sends it back behind. Suter Havens is going to come over. We're under a minute to go in the third quarter. Delaware looking to build a 3-goal lead for the first time in this game. Deckelbaum holds it as Hall comes on. Back he goes to Deckelbaum. Now to Suter Havens. Delaware in their fourth NCAA tournament. They've won 1 game previously.
That was in 1999. They beat UMBC.
Here's a fake from outside by Dixon. Lost the ball, got it back. Delaware just quicker to those ground balls. Barrow checks it away. Took it away from Drew Turner that time. Here comes Barrow. Barrow has operating room. He gives it off to Glanning and deflected by the defense. And taken away by Delaware. What a play. The feed deep down inside, and it almost got by Kip Turner.
Will Barrow just picks the pocket of Drew Turner coming down, but how about the Delaware defense once again knocking down the passes of the Virginia attack?
Long feed upfield, and that'll do it for the third quarter. So we've played three here in Charlottesville, Virginia, and Cinderella is getting fitted for the slipper. Delaware with tremendous defense. Look at the last action here against Gladding. They knock the ball loose, and they are in control, 9-7.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. May I have your attention, please?
Continue to carry on. For my people. Storm, take the form of a verse. Already wrote the last line before I thought of the first. Just when you think that I'm done, I shift shape.
We've all seen them. The makeup artist. The dedicated investor. Mr. Change Your Pants While Driving. Multitasking doubles your risk of an accident. Do it a little less, and now Allstate will give you a bonus. Cash off your renewal bill for every 6 months you don't have an accident. Part of your choice auto, only from Allstate. It's time to make the world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Who first believed in you? Listened to your dreams? Got you on your way? With Citi's people and expertise, you have a partner to help you buy that house. Start that business. Plan a future. We all need a partner that helps turn dreams into realities. Citi, let's get it done.
Since 1989, Coca-Cola has provided more than $35 million in college scholarships. And as the NCAA's first corporate champion, Coca-Cola proudly supports 88 NCAA championships in 23 sports for 360,000 student athletes every year. Satisfying a thirst for learning, both in the classroom and on the field. The Coca-Cola Company and the NCAA.
Delaware 15 minutes away from a major upset. They lead Virginia 9-7 as we get set to begin the fourth quarter. And face-offs with Alex Smith in control has been a big factor in the game.
There you see the motorcycle grip. He holds his man up so a teammate can get the ball. He can pop it to himself. There you see, and he starts to transition. The senior Colonial Athletic Association Player of the Year is a difference maker, and that is certainly holding true here this afternoon in Charlottesville.
13 out of 19, a little bit under his season percentage, but obviously a big factor in this contest.
It's all he does. Bob Schillinglaw during the week said he takes about 150 to 200 a day. A real craftsman.
Hey, just won another one, so that's 14 out of 20, so he's right at 70%.
He heard you.
Deckelbaum holding it now. Now let's see what you said earlier. Will they stick to their game plan with a two-goal lead, or will they perhaps try to get away from it and run clock?
They've been loose all game long. You can't be careless, but you also cannot get away from what's made you successful up to this point. Only three goals scored in that third quarter, two by Delaware. They slowed the pace down a bit, but are still keeping the Cavaliers on their toes.
Smith pressuring Zuiderhavens from behind. Here's the give to Moran, his low shot. Delaware's gonna keep it. And the first 45 seconds are gone here in the fourth quarter.
Heady play, backing up the shot. We talked about Notre Dame's win over Loyola in 2000 in the NCAA first round. That was when it was still a 12-team tournament. Loyola was the number 5 seed. Notre Dame was unseeded, much like 9 through 16 are at this point in time, but traditionally, the Great Western representative was always the last team in the tournament. That was Notre Dame's first tournament win ever.
Here's a low angle shot, and Delaware will keep that one as well. Max Pomper's come on the game as a defensive midfielder for Virginia.
Pomper, the talented freshman out of St. Anthony's in New York, playing some short stick defensive midfield, but nice possession here to start the fourth quarter by the Blue Hens.
J.J. Moran on the move. He's drawing a double team now. Virginia getting a little bit more aggressive defensively. Here's the ball out top. Deckelbaum shot. Backed up by Zuiderhavens.
Quick release by the big lefty out of Owings Mills, Maryland.
A little more pressure now from Virginia.
Well, Virginia's been pressuring them all game long. You know, it's really not getting out of Virginia's comfort zone to really push the perimeter. But if you are the Cavaliers, you want to make sure you don't foul a whole lot. They've done a good job of that today.
Pomper against Zuiderhavens here. Here's an opportunity. Low shot. Did that go in? It looked like it did and came out. A player, wow. Zuiderhavens, raised his hand on the far side. No goal indicated, and Zuiderhavens is showing the official now where it...
Referee Rich Tamburino. In order for it to be a goal, the entire ball has to cross the goal line, and Rich Tamburino, after conferring with single-side official Hans Wittelsberger, is going to say the entire ball crossed the goal line. So it is a goal for Virginia, excuse me, for Delaware. Here we see the shot by Jordan Hall, the sidewinder, hits one pipe, and it looks like it hit the inside of the goal. In college lacrosse, you have flat panels in the back of the 6x6 to ensure that this does not happen. But it looks like that ball did sneak inside of the pipe. The fans here at Klockner don't like it. But the way that lacrosse, a goal is scored, is similar to hockey. The goal has to cross the entire goal, ball has to cross the entire goal line.
Smith won the face again, and Delaware has it. They have their first three-goal lead of the game.
Nice job by the officials to get together. This is what I saw. What did you have?
Zuiderhavens was right on that, protesting to the official.
Well, it doesn't matter if Zuiderhavens was a mile away. He's still going to say it was a goal for his team. And Zuiderhavens did a good job of selling it, but the referees were right in position. That's a tough thing to see. You don't have that typically in lacrosse because you do have those flat backs. You don't have those solid pipes where the ball can ricochet out in then out again. But nonetheless, Delaware with a three-goal cushion.
Kaminsky on the move now with a three-goal lead. They feed it back behind to Cahill. Cahill played by Pomper. Martin Cahill sends it outside. Here's Giordano. He shot Delaware. 12-21 remaining here in the fourth quarter. The ball quickly put in play again. Adam Zuderhavens. Being played by Smith. He's double teamed. The ball is down. Zuderhavens had it covered up. That's a violation.
Withholding call by Hans Wittelsberger. Zuderhavens that time, he knows the double's coming. He's got to spin quick out of that situation to avoid the double team by the Cavalier defense. Nice defense by the Wahoos.
The big sticks. Now give it up to a smaller stick. Drew Thompson, he got the first goal of the game for Virginia. Comes off the pick at midfield, set by Ruck.
Two starter goals, he got the first of the game and then the first of the third period.
Ryan Kelly is now in an offense. Here's a low shot, it's wide. The ground ball is gathered in by Scher.
A little bit of pinball, looked like it hit two or three bodies down there before it got to Scher. All velocity lost. And now Delaware trying to clear it.
Wow, good catch by Drew Turner on that low, wide pass. Turner brings it across. He's got Manny to his left.
We talked about in the open, it's a great pickoff. The focus of Virginia.
Oh,
and
what a
hit. Do Ben Rubior. Rob Smith lays the smack down on Rubior at midfield. They're going to get him for an illegal body check. Here we see the feed to Rubior. He turns. And Rob Smith right there. They're going to say he got Rubior under the chin. I don't know. That looks like it was a from the side. But safety is the first concern here for these student athletes. And Hans Wittelsberger flags Rob Smith for the hit. Illegal body check, so a one-minute penalty coming up for Virginia.
So now Virginia's been 0 for 4 in extra man opportunities. They're down by 3. They almost have to score here.
That's a bang-bang call, and it's a very difficult one to make as a lacrosse official. You look for helmet on helmet. You look for a hit high. The hand's coming up.
Rubier with the feet in close. Couple of fakes, and Scher comes up huge.
How big has Tommy Scher been in this ballgame, especially in the second half with some brilliant saves?
Rubier ran it down. Virginia again, and they shoot it wide.
I think since the end of the first quarter, Scher has been in the head of the Virginia shooters just a little bit because he has come up with everything they've thrown at him and made some stops.
28 seconds remaining on the penalty. Rubier without a point in this game. He has it now. He fires. There's great. Scher again.
Nice job by Scher, making the save and corralling the loose ball. And this is a situation, we talked about it amongst ourselves, Dave. The longer you let a team hang around like Delaware, the more confidence they'll get, let alone with a three-goal lead.
Dixon feeds it, the empty net, and the goal. Oh, they caught Kip Turner out of position, and it's a 4-goal lead. Jordan Hall off the tremendous assist on the play by Curtis Dixon.
Well, basically, Turner was out doubling the ball, trying to make something happen. The 10-man ride for the Cavaliers, and the Delaware defense picks it up. Great pass from who else? Brian Calabrese down low, and there's the empty net. Jordan Hall finishes it. Look at the feed from Curtis Dixon, the finish. And are we looking at a Cinderella, perhaps? Dave Cohen in this first round matchup, Hall his second of the afternoon, 23rd on the year.
A 4-goal lead now with 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And Delaware continuing to vacuum up every ground ball in sight. There's Giordano, knocked away from him, but there's the Blue Hen. Manny in this case, and they are starting to take some of the steam out of Virginia now.
Of Delaware's 11 goals, I only have 4 as being assisted. Dom Starshit talked about this during the week as a flag down on the Cavaliers.
On the play on, Dixon is, he scores. They let him play on with a flag down. It's a 5-goal lead for Delaware.
Curtis Dixon with his 4th of the afternoon off the play-on situation. Ricky Smith again going for that over-the-head check, and he gets burnt behind the cage. I'm sorry, it's Will Barrow, excuse me. Oh, no, it is Ricky Smith. And the hold, he fights through the check. It's J.J. Moran, and Curtis Dixon just sneaks it inside the near post. And Delaware is feeling it right now in the fourth quarter.
Virginia has gone scoreless for 20 minutes in this game. The reign of the national champions, perhaps about to end on their home field. 12-7 Delaware leading with 9:32 to go.
We talked about at the beginning of the third quarter the importance of the third quarter.
So we'll return to Glockner Stadium here in Charlottesville, Virginia, with the Blue Hens leading the Cavaliers 12-7.
Honey, I think I found the problem.
Want an easy way to keep your engine clean? Use Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines. They meet the tough standards to help keep your engine running its best. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines.
I run for a reason.
I run to win. I run because I can.
I run to stay in tune.
I run to kick your...
I run for me.
The Fighting Blue Hens of Delaware, 12. The Virginia Cavaliers, 7. The NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships continue on ESPNU tonight as the UMBC Retrievers face the number 7 Maryland Terrapins in first round action, presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car tonight at 7.
A lot of things going on here in this game. Kip Turner has never lost on this field. Now we see Virginia, they've won 10 of their last 11 NCAA tournament games. We mentioned that heartbreaking loss in the 2005 semis up in Philly to Hopkins.
Alex Smith again, leaving it for Manny. Last time these teams played before this game was in 99 in the NCAA tournament, and Virginia defeated Delaware.
Alex Smith continuing his domination at the faceoff square, now holding a 17-6 advantage in that department.
And he's picked up enough ground balls today to become the all-time NCAA career leader in that category.
Quite an accomplishment. And you know, it's one thing to win those faceoffs, but it's another thing for your team to do something with it once you get in possession. And Delaware certainly has been very prolific here this afternoon.
Timms gets pushed from behind and the flags fly.
Good call by the official, Hans Wittelsberger, trailing that play. Timms got a step on Martin Cahill, and then Cahill trying to make a check from the side, just catches Timms in the back, and that is a tall tree falling down. Mike Timms, 6'5", 222 pounds. The sophomore out of Virginia Beach, Virginia, draws the penalty. And Virginia right now, in order to get back into this game, you got to do it one at a time. And I think if they can get that first one to break the ice and get them some confidence, it's certainly not going to help them exponentially. But it all starts here with the extra man opportunity for the Wahoos.
12-7 is the score. Delaware leading Virginia. Intercepted. Beautiful job by the pole there on defense.
Well, again, the ride from Virginia turned something terrible into something positive as Billings, with an ill-advised pass off his back foot, trying to make a 20-yard diagonal feed through three long poles. But Gladding on the ride wins possession back for Virginia.
Rubior, again, the story and the fact that he has not scored. And there's Scher.
Garrett Billings with the shot. Doesn't move Scher. Doesn't get him off of his goal line. And there you see Tommy Scher, 15 saves on the afternoon, two short of his career high that he just set just last weekend at Towson.
Thompson knocked it away momentarily. But here are the Blue Hens in control again. Here's Dixon. It's 3-on-2 momentarily. Open is Zuderhavens. He doesn't force the action. Wisely slows it down. He knows now The clock is his ally with a five-goal lead.
No question. And look at the poise and the composure of Delaware getting that ball, beating a 10-second count. And then Zuiderhavens picking up that ground ball. He didn't alligator arm it, because when you got Ricky Smith coming at you, you know you're going to receive a vicious check. Kepa's composure, picks up the ground ball, runs away from the check. But that's a situation that Delaware can't afford right now.
Deckelbaum's pass on a bounce, not handled by Hall initially, but he is there to vacuum it up.
Look at Hall just position his body, low center of gravity, gets leverage.
Oh, and a nice move. Beautiful move and a score. What a sensational move by Deckelbaum.
Deckelbaum, the first team all Colonial Athletic Association pick. Credit Jordan Hall winning that ground ball. Here we see Deckelbaum, just a nice split dodge. Keeps the stick in his left hand and shoots it off the noggin of Kip Turner. Nice shot falling down. It caroms off of the helmet of Kip Turner underneath the crossbar. His first of the afternoon, 23rd of the season. The midfielders for Delaware this afternoon really playing a fantastic ball game.
And the violation gives it to Virginia. So it's been a case now of six unanswered goals, and there's a shot wide of the cage again by Gladding. He was hot early. He had four goals on his first four shots, but nothing since.
Like most upset situations, you see the underdog get out to a lead, and you're just like, okay, when is the favorite? In this case, Virginia gonna put things together, make their patented run, and get back into the game, and then close it out. It just simply has not happened here today for the Cavaliers, courtesy of this tenacious Delaware Blue Hen lacrosse team.
Rubier in close. There's Scher. 16 saves now. They are clicking on all cylinders. Offense, defense, specials, goalie.
They're showing everyone why they were the preseason pick, far and away, mind you, to win the Colonial Athletic Association.
An errant pass. Here is Gladding coming in. And Scher stops him.
He's unconscious right now, Dave. He's seeing the ball, he's reacting. That is just a brilliant one-on-one stop against one of the best finishers in all of college lacrosse today.
Drew Turner on the move. Turner gets it up ahead. On the far side, it's played by Smith. You can single out just about everybody on this Delaware team. They lost Sean Burke to an injury early in this half, but they haven't missed him.
Yeah, Calabrese with the rolled ankle. He has not checked back into the ball game. But Delaware, you know, just like in the NFL, next man up. Let's go, Blue Hens. And Delaware's done a remarkable job here this afternoon.
Giordano with an errant pass, one of the few mistakes in this game by the Blue Hens. Dixon just couldn't pull it down. We're under 6 minutes to go. It's all Delaware here in Charlottesville, Virginia. Billings will play it on the far side. He almost lost it out of bounds. You can see Virginia pressing now. Rubio. And there is Scher again. By my count, that's 18 saves and a new personal high.
You talk about faceoffs and goaltending being the keys to your success in the NCAA tournament. Delaware's gotten both today in a big
Crowder
way.
Crowder Washburn gives it up. Shot and a score. And after the goal, a shove down. But credit Chris Hitchborn. And that is the seventh unanswered goal.
Just a great play right here by the Delaware Blue Hen transition. It starts with the save from Scher. They get the ball upfield. Great job by Crowder Washburn to get it over to Hitchborn. He just sets his feet, picks his spot, and Kip Turner right now is just not sharp.
Now, Mark, if I had told you Virginia would go 24 and a half minutes without scoring on their home field, would you believe me?
I'd have told you were crazy. I'd have told you I got some real estate in the swamplands of the Everglades to sell you. I mean, this is just every now and again, this is why you play the games. And this is where the automatic qualifier really comes into play. Because quite frankly, had Delaware not won their conference tournament last weekend against Towson, they might not be here playing this afternoon.
Flag down on the field. We have a stick down on the field as well. The clock running with under 5 minutes to go. Ball comes loose. Zuiderhavens gets it back. Zuiderhavens feeds up top. The shot and it's backed up by Virginia or by Delaware, but what's the call going to be?
Looking for the referee to come over and give us a signal. It's going to be some type of procedure call. Offsides against Virginia. So another extra man opportunity here for Delaware. We talked about those first couple minutes of the third quarter in Virginia. It couldn't have started any better with Drew Thompson scoring only 20 seconds into the third stanza. But then Delaware was able to answer right around that four-minute mark. We talked about that 3, 4, 5 minutes of the third quarter. They took the punch for Delaware, or from Virginia, then counterpunched them right back. And Virginia's been smarting ever since.
Bo Davis on. Also in the game, DJ Whitlake in the extra man offense. Whitlake now to Davis. Davis has room, but don't be in no hurry. Whitlake to Hall. Hall eludes the check, gives it back to Whitlake. Goes to the right hand. Very patient. Teams are going to be at equal strength. Low shot, save Turner. Played by Kip, who has never lost a game on this field. But right now he's down 14-7.
Nice save by Turner. Good shot by Zuider Havens.
Pomper sends it cross field. Gladding loses the ball, and here come the Blue Hens. We're under 4 minutes to go now.
Well, how unlikely is it going to be? But Delaware will be playing next Sunday in Navy Marine Corps Stadium in Annapolis, Maryland. And they are going to await the winner of the Maryland Terrapins and the UMBC Retrievers, which is coming up next here on ESPNU, live from College Park, Maryland.
Dixon plays it. Dixon double teamed. The goalie Turner is out, hacking away at it. And look who comes away with it. The crease is open. Here's a shot from up high. And a defenseman, I believe Tim Shaw, got a piece of that to deflect it.
Yeah, it looked like Tenney Clawson jumped in there to deflect it out of the goal and keep Delaware from scoring their 15th marker of this ball game.
Under 3 minutes to play. Delaware 14, Virginia 7. The Blue Hens about to pull off big upsets in first round action in NCAA tournament history. On the home field of Virginia.
And I like the adjustment that Tommy Scher made on Danny Gladding coming from behind the cage, stepping away from the line, decreasing the angle of this talented attackman.
Gladding working for the shot. Patrick Beal is on him.
Speaking of Beal, who can forget his terrific trail check, keeping Gladding from a one-on-one. Some key moments in this game as Delaware is looking better and better to advance through their first quarterfinal ever. Excuse me, their second quarterfinal in the history of their program.
Giannone came out of there with the ball, but we have a flag that stops play with 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go.
Looks like we're going to have an off-ball situation here. A slash against Virginia. Some frustration settling in for the Wahoos. As Stop Starcher looks on. And 2 minutes and 4 seconds away from the end of the 2007 Virginia lacrosse season.
No doubt this will be the biggest win in Delaware lacrosse history.
And we talked about their first round win years ago in 1999 against UMBC. Then they were defeated in the quarterfinals by the same Virginia program.
We should mention, too, Delaware had lost 20 straight times to top 10 teams in lacrosse. But they're about to change a lot of that history today.
That 99 team led by John Grant Jr., who has been so prolific in the Major Lacrosse League with the Rochester Rattlers.
Zuider Havens sends it back to Deckelbaum. They're going to double him up. Now it's like the end of a fight. They're going to count it down here as we're down to a minute 40 to go, and the outcome no longer in doubt.
Real aggressive play, and we're going to have a slash call against Delaware here.
Well, this gives us the opportunity now to take a look at our Warrior great save of the game.
Here we see Tommy Scher, the netminder for Delaware. Here you see he steps up, decreases the angle of Danny Gladden, keeping him out of the net. And here we see Rubio with the shot low. That was a nasty bouncer gobbled up by Tommy Scher. And here's the latest, the one-on-one against Danny Gladding. Great job by Tommy Scherer. There's a good look at the junior netminder out of Owings Mills, Maryland, Mount St. Joseph High School. 18 saves on the afternoon.
Danny Gladding hit his first four shots of the game. He's missed all six since then.
And credit Tommy Scherer with making at least three brilliant saves on Danny Gladding.
Rubier, by the way, 0 for 6. Here's Thompson, who had the first goal of the game, and he finally ends the drought as Virginia gets on the board with a minute 28 to go. They went 28 minutes and 16 seconds between scores.
The proud senior playing his last game in a Virginia Cavalier uniform, doesn't go out without a fight, takes on the checks of Rob Smith, and look at that beautiful bounce shot. About 2 yards inside the crease, nestles inside the far post. Nice shot by Thompson. Virginia calls for a timeout right here. I think the message in this huddle is going to be, we win with class, we lose with class. Let's keep our heads, play aggressive, but keep it under control for this last minute 28.
So you could sense in this game about midway through the first quarter that Delaware was not going to be intimidated, that they would be able, and they were able to dictate how this game was played.
Ben Rubior, the Tuwartan, but here's an NCAA tournament fact. Three teams have lost in the first round after winning the national championship. Syracuse in 2005 to UMass, Princeton in 1999, and you got to go all the way back to Johns Hopkins in 1975. So Virginia looks like they will be the fourth defending national champion to lose in the first round of the NCAA tournament. The first since 2005, but the fourth all time.
Virginia came in averaging 11.6 goals per game. That's good for number six in the country. They've been held to 8 goals by terrific defensive play by the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, who've more than lived up to their nickname.
Well, I think when you look at the trend of that fact, the Hopkins 75 team, that was under Bob Scott, a national championship team led by Bruce Konowalczyk, Jack Thomas, seniors, they're gone the next year. 1999, that's the first year that Bill Tierney's without that tremendous trio of attackmen, Massey, Hubbard, and Hess. They lose in the first round to Syracuse. And of course, in 2005, Syracuse loses after the national championship team featuring Mikey Powell, Brian Knee, other great players for the Syracuse Orange. And here you're going to see Virginia go down in the first round after losing that tremendous senior class. Matt Ward, Michael Culver, Kyle Dixon, Matt Posley, J.J. Morrissey. So that's the one thing that all these first round losses by defending national champions really have in common, the loss of senior leadership from the year before.
Well, Dom Starcher said the ball just doesn't pop into the net for us this year like it did a year ago. And we've certainly seen the lack of firepower here today, but credit Delaware on what they did on defense.
Just a great team effort, a great game plan by Bob Schillinglaw. And people were arguing all year that the Colonial Athletic Association is down as a whole. But I tell you what, the Delaware Blue Hens carrying that flag proudly here in the NCAA tournament for that conference.
Down now to the final 35 seconds of the game. Delaware has it. And the Blue Hen faithful are really enjoying this sun-splashed afternoon here in Charlottesville. Delaware defeated Virginia here once before back in 1987, and they'll begin the countdown here very shortly.
Delaware dictated the tempo in this one from start to finish, the major reason why they are going to Annapolis.
The ball comes free. 2 seconds, 1 second, there it is. The Fighting Blue Hens of Delaware have upset the defending national champions, the Virginia Cavaliers, and Delaware plays on in the 2007 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Championships.
Just great to see from the vantage point of new blood getting into the tournament, but Virginia, such a classy program, phenomenal team. They're going to be back next year in a big way with a great recruiting class, but this day belongs to the Delaware Blue Hens.
Bob Schillinglaw, we told you he's the dean of all the coaches in the tournament, 29 years. Hasn't broken out the big smile yet.
They'll advance to the quarterfinals for only the second time in the history of the program. They won their first Colonial Athletic Association tournament last week. Now they win their second NCAA tournament game in the history of their program. Hats off to the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens.
Don't go away, because we're going to talk to the head coach of the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, Bob Schillinglaw, and his record-setting face-off specialist, Alex Smith, when we return to Charlottesville here on ESPNU.
The NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships exclusively on ESPNU. Just four more victories left to be crowned this year's champion. Anything less and the season is over. The championships continue with UMBC versus Maryland next on ESPNU.
I got Verizon high-speed internet. Now I post images of my art to share with people all over the world.
I won my classic longboard from an online auction.
My family's safer online with Verizon security features.
Spread the word. Millions of people are doing more online with Verizon high-speed internet.
Installing it was simple. Now I track storms from home before I set sail.
I run a website for my league.
And you can do more of what you love online for a great low price. No wonder more people are choosing Verizon for high-speed internet. Just call 1-866-545-9322. That's 1-866-545-9322 to sign up today. Pass it on.
I love video chatting with my new boyfriend, who I met online.
Check it. I buy and download my tunes faster, so I always have the latest beats.
Hey, chill. You'll get it.
Phone, broadband, TV, wireless. Verizon.
The NCAA Lacrosse Championships presented on ESPNU by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. No doubt about it, the biggest upset in this year's NCAA Lacrosse Tournament. The national champions are out. Delaware, convincingly 14-8 winners here in Charlottesville on the home field of the University of Virginia.
Well, again, we referenced the 2000 first-round upset, Notre Dame over Loyola. Loyola was a 5 seed. But here you have, in the 16-team tournament, the number 2 seed, defending national champions, fall to the Delaware Blue Hens on their home field. I think I'm going to call this definitely the biggest upset since the tournament went to the round, to the 16-team format. But this might be the biggest first-round upset in the history of the NCAA lacrosse tournament.
And excellent sportsmanship on the part of both teams as we check the brackets, beginning first with the bottom bracket. Delaware a winner over Virginia, and they await the winner of the next game, which you'll see right here on ESPNU, and that will be Maryland and UMBC, a neighborhood battle. The other quarterfinals will have Hopkins and Georgetown.
Yeah, two great quarterfinals next weekend. Hopkins and Georgetown will tussle up at Princeton. Delaware will travel to Annapolis, and now they sit tight to find out who their opponent will be a week from today.
And the other half of the bracket, Duke an easy winner, and North Carolina in a game delayed one day because of weather conditions prevailing over Navy. So I guess the seeding held up in that one.
Seeding holds true, very close game. And for the third time this year, North Carolina and Duke will duke it out, no pun intended, down in Annapolis next Sunday. And then you look at the bottom half of that bracket, Albany and Cornell, great matchup, two speed teams, two transition teams. They'll face each other next Saturday at Princeton.
Right now, we're going to go down field level and speak with one of the outstanding performers for the Fighting Blue Hens of Delaware. He's the all-time NCAA leader in faceoffs and ground balls. Congratulations, Alex Smith.
Thank you very much.
How did you guys do it? What was the game plan?
Well, we knew coming in that they were going to be an excellent team, obviously, and we worked all week on limiting our turnovers and really playing well, like trying to slow down the game a little bit for us. And honestly, the keys to the game were Tommy Scher played an unbelievable game. I mean, I don't know what he had, 20 saves, 19 saves, unbelievable. And then our offense just played incredible as well. They took good shots, which is key, and we didn't turn the ball over as much as we have in past games.
Alex, you guys played so loose with so much energy all game long from start to finish. You really beat Virginia at their own game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, coming in here, we knew that Virginia was obviously an excellent team. They were the 2 seed. And I think this is the first top 10 team we've beaten in a number of years. But we tried to look past that. I mean, if you look underneath the jerseys, it's just athlete versus athlete, and we knew we matched up with them well, so that's what we really tried to concentrate on.
And Alex, now you advance to the quarterfinals. You'll play the winner of Maryland UMBC. Any preference there, or are you just glad you're playing for another weekend?
Honestly, I told Coach after the game, I said, we're practicing Monday, and that's, you know, it's just fun to hang out with these guys every week, week in, week out, since, you know, September, really. And we just won another week together, and I'm a senior, so I'm glad I get another week.
Alex Smith, congratulations on the win and your record-setting performance.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Alex Smith, who dominated the faceoffs today, just as Delaware dominated Virginia, winning it by a 14-8 count.
And again, you talk about him winning the faceoffs, but it's also what your team does when you get it. Delaware just did a great job.
Well, he credited his goalie and his offense for being patient, but you also have to credit that defense and all the ground balls that they picked up.
And how about crediting the head coach? We got him right now, Coach Bob Schillinglaw of the Delaware Blue Hens. Coach, congratulations. A hard-fought win and just a great day for Delaware lacrosse.
Yeah, thank you very much. Guys, the last 2 weeks, it's the most focused in my coaching career and playing career, to be honest with you, that I've had had the honor of a group to be involved in. And it seems to be really carrying out on the field. With this is our third great win in 2 weeks. We're excited to be able to move on and hopefully we'll continue to play the same level of play that we've showed today.
We talked about the keys to the game beforehand. Face-offs, check. Alex Smith, you mentioned he's a doorstop for any potent offense, but team defense was another one. And boy, did your team defense show up today. Rob Smith, Calabrese, and Tommy Scher between the pipes, just a great effort.
I couldn't be more proud of that defensively. We have been playing great defense weeks. I'd like to certainly give credit to our associate head coach, Carroll. He handles the defense, does a great job, but I mean, they just, be honest with you, I kind of felt we played Virginia style. I mean, we tried to get the ball on the ground, we tried to create turnovers, we tried to force an offense to rush their passing, and it resulted in turnovers and goals for us as well. And I was very happy that we seemed to be making good decisions about what to do on offense, when to do it, and when to go hard to the cage and when to move it to the next guy and when to take the shot.
Coach, tell us about your tremendous face-off man, Alex Smith.
He's just a delight to work with. I mean, the 4 years that he's been involved with the program, there's no question that I think he is the top face-off. He might be the top face-off player of all time. You know, you score a goal, or if you give up a goal, you just know you got a great opportunity to get a possession afterwards and then and try to move on from there. So he had a terrific day today. I mean, he did everything that I felt he could do. And, you know, obviously he was a big part of our success today.
So you go on now to face the winner of the next game, UMBC against Maryland. You'll have to find a place to watch that game here.
Yeah, I mean, we may change our travel plans right now. You know, might have to give a few excuses to professors early tomorrow morning. We haven't even started finals yet. Our first final starts Friday. So, but yeah, we're excited. I don't care who it is at this point. Obviously, I just want to move on and keep playing.
Well, Alex said you get another week of lacrosse together, Coach, and how sweet is it, to go back and only have to take exams without the lacrosse. This makes that trip back to Delaware much sweeter.
It's just unbelievable. I mean, our guys are so excited, and the opportunity to continue to coach these guys, it's a pure, they're great guys, and again, I got another week to be with them. I appreciate it.
Tommy saves in the Columbia Championship game, and today he does that with an unbelievable performance.
Great. I don't know, you know, I don't know what the final stats were, but, you know, Tommy did play spectacular. I think, you know, the combination of our defense playing aggressively and creating shots that, that D plus, I mean, that one-on-one at the end of the game where I think whoever the attackman was, I don't remember this
Gladding.
Point, Gladding that he stuffed right there at the end. I mean, you talk about a major save, but a major uplift to the team. He and Smitty just really took the team, put them on the shoulders, and we followed along.
Well, Bob, we certainly congratulate you. We mentioned you're the dean of the coaches in this tournament, and I don't think you've ever had a bigger win and a more deserved win than today.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate it, and we're excited to be able to continue our season and looking forward to next weekend, whoever it may be that we play.
There's the head coach of the University of Delaware, Fighting Blue Hens, victorious and moving on in the NCAA Lacrosse Championships, Bob Schillinglaw. So Delaware wins it 14-8, and as you look ahead to the next game tonight, How does Delaware potentially match up with Maryland or UMBC?
Well, I think with UMBC and Maryland, I don't think they have a faceoff guy that can match Alex Smith. But with UMBC, you talk about a very potent attack. Westervelt, Gallagher, and Ratcliffe going up against that outstanding defense of Maryland, Wittenberg, Sanoski, and McGill. Whoever can win that matchup is going to advance. And whoever gets through, it's going to be a haymaker next weekend in Annapolis.
So our final score once again, the University of Delaware 14 and Virginia 8. Coming up next, UMBC takes on number 7 Maryland. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. We are college. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Once again, the final score, the University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens 14, Virginia 8. For Mark Dixon and our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Dave Cohen. So long from Virginia. Now let's check in with Dave Ryan and Quint Kesenick for a preview of the UMBC-Maryland game.
All right, thank you. Here at Byrd Stadium, College Park, Maryland, we are getting set for the second matchup of the season between Maryland-Baltimore County, the Retrievers, and the seventh-seeded Maryland Terrapins out of the ACC. Let's take a look at this side of the bracket. How about Johns Hopkins? A thrill over Notre Dame last night, 11-10. And Michael Kimmel, the freshman, won it for the Blue Jays in overtime. Another overtime game that we saw on ESPNU. Georgetown knocking off Princeton as Brennan Cannon got the game-winning goal. 1 minute into OT, and Delaware has upset Virginia. Defending national champs are finished. Last game of the bracket is here tonight. We'll have it for you tonight at ESPNU. Quint Kesenick along with Dave Ryan. Looking forward to this one tonight. Happy Mother's Day to all you moms out there. Maryland really an up-and-down type year for Dave Cottle, their head coach. Injuries everywhere, including Harry Alford, their starting goalie.
Yeah, but the one mainstay when Alford wasn't in the lineup was the defense. And this, to me, is one of the best defensive teams in the nation. It starts with Steve Wittenberg, Ray McGill, Joe Sanoski, and Ryan Clark, their seniors. And look at the data for Maryland this year. 10-5 record. What has amazed me is the way they've been able to score goals. They lost a lot of scoring punch from last year's senior class in Joe Walters, Ian Healy, Billy McGlone, and somehow they found ways to score goals this season. And surprisingly, look at the man-up offense. Terrific. And Mike Phipps, the attackman, has really raised his level in terms of distributing the ball.
Speaking of offense, that has not been the problem for the Retrievers and their head coach, Don Zimmerman. First time in school history, 330 goal scorers led by Drew Westervelt. They can put it in the net, no doubt about it.
And I love their attack. They have three guys who are all threats, and they complement each other so well. You know, Coach Zimmerman for years has been known as a defensive coach, but this year he's let it go. And this is a team getting up and down the field, eighth in the nation in scoring. Up has been sensational at UMBC for about the last 3 or 4 years. There's nobody who does it better than Coach Zimmerman and the Retrievers. And Cale Ratcliffe, they call him Tugboat, and you're going to see why in a couple minutes. 37 goals. He's from Canada, and those guys just know how to shoot.
He's about 5'8", 230 pounds. It'll be fun to watch tonight. Cale Ratcliffe, a freshman out of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. Now, the question is, does UMBC have a chance here? A little chip on their shoulder, because it's kind of like the haves versus the have-nots. We're in this beautiful palatial stadium here, Byrd Stadium on the College Park campus in Maryland. UMBC comes in kind of the team, the underdog in a way, and for sure, look at the series. They're 4-24 all time against the Terps.
Yeah. Did Delaware have a shot against Virginia? Did UMass have a shot last year? Well, the answer is yes, and UMBC's got a shot.
Anything can happen. It's the lacrosse championships on ESPNU. We are underway with the great games all weekend long. Two teams from the Washington, Baltimore area go head to head next.
No curb appeal. Hate the color. Oh, honey, this is it.
What you got there is an infestation.
A lot of life happens in your car. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 quality ProClean gasolines help clean your engine as you drive.
The pink wasn't so bad.
So you can focus on more important things. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 quality ProClean gasolines.
Amazing.
We've all seen them. The makeup artist. The dedicated investor. Mr. Change Your Pants While Driving. Multitasking doubles your risk of an accident. Do it a little less, And now Allstate will give you a bonus. Cash off your renewal bill for every 6 months you don't have an accident. Part of your choice auto, only from Allstate. It's time to make the world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
What's the matter, Mom?
Well, I'd love to have new floors in here, but I don't know how to tell your dad.
Come into the Home Depot today and get professional carpet installation for your whole house for the special price of just $99. Getting luxurious carpet is easier than ever with this exceptional from the Home Depot. Don't miss it.
Mom, that one's new motorcycle.
The Terps touch Testudo, getting set to take on the Retrievers tonight here at Burns Stadium. We're a few moments away from faceoff in the first round. There have been some amazing games. You and I have called two overtime games already as Notre Dame fell to Johns Hopkins last night. Homewood Field a few minutes away from where we are here in College Park in Baltimore. And then today, Georgetown surviving. Six straight trip for Dave Urich's team to the quarterfinals.
Yeah, and congratulations to Georgetown and Bob Schilling, Delaware, and all the seven teams that have, you know, moved on into the quarterfinals. It all started yesterday at noon down in Durham. And Duke, a real big story this week. They're back in the playoffs, and they dominated this Providence game from the start. Getting the ball on the carpet in their riding game and then converting in transition. I thought they were very impressive, up 9-1 at halftime. Matt Danowski set a career high for assists with 7. He also had 2 goals, and Duke is a team right now with Zach Greer inside, Ned Crotty, so many different weapons, such great team speed, and the Blue Devils advance into the quarterfinals with a resounding victory.
Easy victory, 18-3 in the final. On Tobacco Road, arch rival North Carolina in the national quarterfinals at Annapolis next week. 18-3, a blowout win. Duke now has won 10 straight games. Cornell, the only undefeated team in Division I, took on Towson at Shoal Caulfield in Ithaca. This was an easy Big Red win.
Yeah, and Cornell really dominated this game early. David Mitchell and Pittard got it going. Max Seibold was terrific as well. And at the end of the day, Towson had 5 extra man goals. They only could manage 1 goal in even strength situations. Cornell the ball extremely well. They took a 5-0 lead after the first quarter and then put the game in the hands of their goaltender, Matt McMonagle, who was, again, sensational. And to me, it's really a shame that Matt right there is not a two-time finalist.
Tying a career best 19 saves. We saw this one on ESPNU last night. What a game. 2 rain delays. The Fighting Irish, the third seed, Johns Hopkins Blue Jays. This was tight, going down to overtime.
Well, I tell you, the Fighting Irish really showed me something this game. I thought Brian Hubsman was incredible. You know, really had Hopkins and Dave Petromala on the ropes. From an emotional standpoint, I give all these athletes a lot of credit. Dealing with the 2 rain delays, Paul Rabel was terrific. I thought Jake Byrne finished his shots. But in the end, Ryan Hoff would tie the score with 9 seconds to go in this game, and we headed to overtime.
A tremendous tally there, but just about a minute in.
Mike Kimmel.
Great move from Michael Kimmel. He's a freshman. Took advantage of a good matchup for Hopkins. He buries it in the back of the net for his first game winner in overtime.
Another 1-goal victory for the Blue Jays. They will move on and play Georgetown. Those are 2 programs that don't exactly get along, so that should be a terrific quarterfinal match. There's the top half of the bracket. Duke and Carolina in the quarterfinals. That game at the Naval Academy in Albany and Cornell. 2 teams from upstate New York. That's your turf. Where's Syracuse?
Syracuse did not make the NCAA tournament. Thanks for reminding us on that. Hopkins, Georgetown will meet as well. Should be a tremendous matchup. That is at Princeton. The Tigers for a 3rd time hosting the quarters, and they will not play in their own stadium. We'll have more come up from College Park right after this.
Honey, I think I found the problem.
Want an easy way to keep your engine clean? Use Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines. They meet the tough standards to help keep your engine running its best. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines.
I run for a reason.
I run to win. I run because I can.
I run to stay in tune.
I run to kick your...
I run for me.
Doc, I can't stop. It's always one more hit, one more score. Kids stare at us in the street. I thought it would stop after college. But now at the MLL, people want to know how much they weigh and what they feel like. It's bad enough when I just had one. But with four, it's out of control.
Have you ever considered removing them?
Guys, we're out of here. She's a quack.
Oh, man.
Dude, you're addicted to what your stick did.
What's the matter, Mom?
Well,